1 minute.
Seconds.
He is a member of the jazz band and also involved in the photography course at the high school. He is also involved in the EKG and phlebotomy program. Dalton's future plans are undecided at the moment, but he will be
20.
Successful in anything he pursues. Varsity cheerleaders.
9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4. 3, 2, go.
It's time for a football in East Texas. This is Jerry Hansen. Welcome to our Carthage High School football broadcast. Larry Allen will provide the play-by-play. Mark Harris will describe the action, and Jason Wade will be live on the sidelines. Our broadcast is brought to you in part by Panola College, Pennergy, Courtney Construction, Elliott Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram, Howell's AC, Pritchard & Abbott, Prosperity Bank, XL Ford, and the First State Bank & Trust Company. The Bulldogs, under the direction of Coach Scott Surratt, have earned 7 state titles in the past 11 years. Can the 2020 season be another championship run? Other sponsors include Central Baptist Church of Carthage, Carthage Flower Shop, Panola National Bank, Carthage Furniture, Pippin Motor Company, Hudson Financial, Farmer State Bank, Kane Hardware, and State Farm agent Tate Barber. Remember, you can hear our live broadcast on KGAS 104.3 FM, but you can also hear and watch the game on your iPhone, iPad, computer, Android, or your television. Go to easttexastoday.com and click Watch Now. Thanks to these sponsors for making this broadcast possible. Bauer Furniture Company, University of Texas Health, Quick Stop of Carthage, Carthage Missionary Baptist Church, Country Fresh Pizza, The Hope Clinic, and Maxflow Chemicals. We'll be back with our starting lineup right after a word from Panola College.
Panola College wants to give you the opportunity to do college your way. With courses online, in-class, or hybrid instruction, Panola offers a variety of options to fit your needs. Panola College knows your time is important, so you're offered 8 and 16-week courses to accommodate your schedule. Check out the list of courses to find the right fit for you. Do college your way at panola.edu.
Now with tonight's starting lineup, brought to you by Center Glass, here's your play-by-play announcer, Larry Allen.
Bulldogs in 8 years. As best I can determine, this is the first time they have played on grass since 2013 when we played at Jasper and also at Huntington. So a grass field and different facilities than we have at Carthage, and we're going to point out some of those to you as we go along. But first of all, we're going to take a look at the Bulldog offense. Offensive coordinator is Clint Inslee. Luke Jackson, is the center, 6 foot, 275-pound senior. The right guard is Karsten Williams, 6'2", 330-pound senior. Left guard is Zach Carlisle, 6'1", 325-pound junior. Left tackle, T. Callum, 5'10", 310-pound senior. And Cade Staten is the right tackle, 6'3", 200-pound senior. All right, we'll be back with the wideouts and the tight end right after this from KGIS.
Throughout Texas, Louisiana, and New Mexico, one of the largest independent oil field service companies is Pinergy, ranked number one in the United States for total number of wells drilled. You'll likely recognize Pinergy Carthage top management, Randy Taylor, Brandon Taylor, Andy Snow, Justin Taylor, and Steve Nations. At the Austin corporate office, senior management offers a combined 400 years experience regarding energy services. No more. Check the website, Pinergy.com, or call 903-693-8400. Pinergy.
If you need construction done, check with Carlos and Shane Courtney at Courtney Construction Incorporated. They're the best in the business, whether it's pipeline or dirt work, oil field maintenance, or general construction. The Courtneys are well experienced. Call them at 903-694-2911 or drop by 1300 Northeast Loop in Carthage. When you need it done right, call Courtney Construction Incorporated. They'll get it done.
Hey folks, it's Aaron Hicks with Elliott Dodge of Carthage. We are kicking off this football season with two great sales events, Ram Power Days and Jeep Adventure Days. This month at Elliott Dodge of Carthage, you can buy a brand new 2020 Ram 1500 at 0% for 72 months and make no payments for 90 days. You can also get the same offer on a new 2020 Jeep Grand Cherokee. The deals don't stop there. We have fantastic incentives on every new vehicle in stock. So call, come by, or check us out anytime online at ElliottDodgeCarthage.com.
All right, second time this season for the broadcast crew to be under the stars, so to speak, on the roof of a press box. Also down at Jasper this year, I was not able to be there because I was quarantining at the time. But we've got great weather tonight, clear skies and 66 degrees here in Shepherd. Montrell Smith is the tight end for the Bulldogs tonight, 6'3", 220-pound senior. The wide receivers will include Noah Patty, 5'9", 160-pound sophomore, and Montrell Hatton, a 6'1", 175-pound sophomore. So two sophomores at the wideouts. That's great news. They're going to be back for a couple of years. Hatton with 21 receptions, 332 yards, and four touchdowns. And they'll also see at wideout Craig McNew, a 5'11", 170-pound senior, 26 receptions, 445 yards, and three touchdowns. And Cavante Brown-Hoskins, 12 receptions, 192 yards, three touchdowns for Brown-Hoskins. Those are the wideouts and the tight end. And we'll have the backfield for you when Bulldog football returns.
How's air conditioning and electrical?
Is Spider-Man there?
Well, I don't know where you can find Spider-Man.
Don't you always have something for everyone?
Well, we can help everyone with heating, cooling, and electrical repair needs. We install new systems and whole home generators, too. We don't know where any superheroes are, but we always have super prices.
Super prices? I never heard of that, superhero.
Since 1974, we've got something for everyone. Hal's Air Conditioning and Electrical. Call 903-693-7451.
Pritchard and Abbott Incorporated are evaluating consultants. What does that mean? They appraise minerals, industrial, utility properties, and data services. From their evaluations of a net worth, fair taxes can be levied. Pritchard and Abbott Incorporated, doing their part to be a good neighbor and helping our part of the world stay strong and solvent. Pritchard and Abbott Incorporated, evaluating consultants.
There's nothing like football season in Texas. As the number one ranked bank by Forbes in 2012, Prosperity Bank wishes the number one ranked Carthage Bulldogs good luck as they begin their quest for another state championship. Prosperity Bank offers exceptional mortgage rates, low auto and commercial rates, along with a variety of deposit products including online banking and now mobile banking too. With over 200 locations across Texas, Prosperity Bank can meet all your banking needs just about anytime, anywhere. Go Bulldogs, all the way to another state championship. Prosperity Bank, member FDIC, housing lender.
We return to Pirate Stadium here in Shepherd. Here's the backfield. Kai Horton, 6'4", 220-pound senior, two-year starter, and he has a goal. He has a goal to set a new season record for a quarterback at Carthage High School, and that is for the completion percentage. I think it's around 70%. He's at 71.3 right now. Outstanding. You're 97 of 136. 1,553 yards, 17 touchdowns for Kai Horton. He'll be backed up by Javarian Rottmore, who was the leading rusher in last week's ball game. He's a 5'10", 170-pound junior. He has 131 yards rushing, two touchdowns for Rockmore. Nick Stewart is the fullback. We may not see him tonight. Coach Surratt telling me after his interview that he may be held out because of a nagging injury. Stewart, 5'11", 195-pound senior. The tailback, Mason Courtney, 5'10", 185-pound senior, 746 yards on the ground this year, 16 TDs, 12 receptions also for 171 yards and one touchdown. And he'll be backed up by Cavante Brown Hoskins, 5'11", 185-pound senior. Incidentally, normally backing up Nick Stewart is Cy Schumacher. You heard Coach Surratt in the interview say that, unfortunately, his injury required surgery, which he had on Wednesday of this week. He is out for the season. So, again, it's Horton, Stewart, and Courtney in the backfield for the Bulldogs. Take a look at the defense right after this.
This is Baylor Bardwell with XL Ford. Hunting season is here, and we have our sight aimed on saving you money with our lineup of quality pre-owned cars, trucks, and SUVs. You don't have to have the patience of a hunter to bag one. Come into XL Ford now and let our friendly team find the right vehicle for your budget. Their knowledge and experience, backed by our reliable service department, are sure to please. Excellent prices, excellent selection, and excellent service at XL Ford or on the net at xlford.net.
First State Bank and Trust knows evolving 21st century banking makes it important to have a financial partner who ensures the monetary services you need and want are available and accessible through technology. Checking and saving accounts, personal debit and credit cards, auto, home, and personal loans are connected through internet and mobile applications and contact with people when you need it. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender, 110 West Spinola, Carthage, 903-693-6606, fsbcarthage.com.
Hi, this is Monty Pierce, pastor at Central Baptist Church. We're all aware that our country, and in fact our whole world, is under attack by an invisible virus, COVID-19. Well, there is another unseen force in our world just as devastating, if not more. We call it sin. Fortunately, there is a cure. His name is Jesus. We invite you to join us at Central Baptist as we seek to learn more about this God who loves us so much. On Sunday mornings, we have Bible study for all ages at 9:30, and the worship service begins at 10:45. If you can't join us in person, we are live on KGAS AM and FM on cable channel 18, as well as Facebook Live and YouTube.
All right, depending on where we're playing, we have varying degrees of access to the officials, so we can get their names and basically hear little access, really none. So I will tell you that the introduction of the officials is brought to you each week by the City of Carthage. We really appreciate them, the best little town in East Texas, gas capital of the world. Incidentally, that's why this station is named KGAS, the gas capital of the world, and home to a seven-time state football champion. That's the Carthage Bulldogs. Well, Darren Preston is in his 10th year as the defensive coordinator, and here is his starting lineup tonight. On the defensive line, and we've got one change. At one end is going to be Zycarian Tatum, number 28, 5'8", 220-pound junior. Tatum at one end. The rush end is Jakerick Johnson, number 20, 5'9", 175-pound junior. At tackle is Bobby Cooks, another junior, 5'10", 265. And at nose is Kylan Lister, 6'1", 260, and he is a senior. So three juniors and a senior there. It's Johnson, Lister, Cooks, and Tatum. All right, we'll take a look at the linebackers right after this from your Sports Beat station.
Carthage Flower Shop, located on the square in downtown Carthage, where they carry an array of fresh flowers and silk pot plants. Carthage Flower Shop also carries Colonial Candles, Mantra Bands, Hickory Farms, The Naked Bee, and Willow Tree Angels. Shop Carthage Flower Shop. They will help you with all your floral needs.
East Texas is a wonderful community, and at Panola National Bank, we're proud to call it home. That's why you'll find our bank and our employees helping others wherever you look. From supporting local schools to volunteering with local charity events, we're part of the fabric that weaves the community and its people together. When it comes to financial service needs, local is better. We provide convenient banking services so we can help our community grow. Panola National Bank, member FDIC, and an equal housing lender.
At Carthage Furniture, Monty has chest freezers from 5 cubic feet for $239 to 9 cubic feet at $419, and all sizes and prices in between. At Carthage Furniture, find 110-volt window AC units starting at $349. They even have a 15,000 BTU window AC that will cool up to three rooms for only $549. Remember, Carthage Furniture offers free delivery. The U Store on West Panola, right behind the car wash, where Rosa speaks Spanish.
Well, one thing about going on the road to broadcast Bulldog football, it really makes you appreciate the facilities that we have in Carthage. And so I'm going to ask Mario Salazar if he would pan up. Mario, just pan over and show everyone the scoreboard that we have here in Shepherd, okay? All right. And, again, we are in Shepherd, Texas, home of the Shepherd Pirates. And we'll talk a little bit about their football team here in just a little bit. We're going to look at the linebackers now. And at the mic backer is going to be Camden Foster. Excuse me, in the middle is the mic backer is Kip Lewis, pardon me, 6'2", 195-pound junior. 69 tackles. That's tops on the team this year, 12 quarterback pressures. The wheel backer is Camden Foster, 5'10", 185-pound junior, 54 tackles, 2 sacks for him. Freddie Lynch, 5'9", 165-pound junior, is the Sam backer. He is on the strong side. So it's going to be Lewis in the middle, Foster and Lynch on the outside. We'll be back with the secondary right after this from your Sports Beat station.
No reason to drive out of town to get an amazing deal on any new Chevrolet vehicle. We won't be undersold. Hello, East Texas. Will Blackwell here with Pippin Motor Company, and we're aggressively seeking your business. All Chevrolet vehicles are clearly marked on the vehicle, reduced on our website, and discounted right up front to eliminate any need of going out of town. We have researched our competitors and are certain you will save the most money right here at home. Come experience a better way to buy a vehicle right here at home. That's Pippin Motor Company just across from Panola College or online at pippinmotorcompany.com.
We want you to join the winning team at Hudson Financial Group and let us assist you in finding the best game plan for your insurance and investment needs. We are licensed with over 30 companies to provide you with the best coverages and prices, whether you need personal, commercial, or life insurance. At HFG, we strive to prepare our clients for the unexpected and their future. Stop by our office at 1519 West Panola or give us a call at 903-693-7874 and let us help you with your winning game plan today. And go Dawgs.
Navigating 21st century business financial currents can be trying, even for seasoned commercial endeavors. Get assistance charting your course with trustworthy commercial lending officers at Farmers State Bank, Carthage Center, Joaquin, and Shelbyville. FSB offers 116 years stability, a finance source for expansion and equipment purchase to help ensure growth on the path you want. Committed to East Texas business long-term success, your commercial financial request decisions are made by officers you likely know already. FSBCTX.com, Farmers State Bank, member FDIC, equal housing lender.
A reminder that if you're listening to us on KGAS, you can watch this game. Because of the virus this year, teams can live stream their games, and here's how you do it. Quickly go to your computer. Go to easttexastoday.com, easttexastoday.com. Then scroll down just slightly. Click on the letters KGAS. Scroll down until you see the Carthage Bulldog mascot. Click on that mascot, and you should be able to see Pirate Stadium here in Shepherd. Once again, remember, we're on a grass field, so if the field looks a little pale green, it's because it's grass. Okay,
it is
natural grass, and it is pale. Okay, because of the season of the year. All right. Incidentally, I will tell you that Coach Surratt concerned about that. Yes, he is, because you know, one thing about natural turf fields, they're smooth, should be no holes on the field. That's not the case necessarily with grass. So I don't think our ones are going to be playing very long here tonight, from what he told me. All right, let's take a look now at the secondary for the Bulldogs. At one of the corners, getting close to a school record, is Zay Woods. He has 6 interceptions for the year. The record is 8 back in 2012 by Brian Bolton. Zay Woods, 6 foot, 150-pound senior. The other corner, he's got 4 interceptions himself. 33 tackles for the year for Brandon King, 5'9", 160-pound junior. And the safeties, the free safety, is Austin Morgan, 6 foot, 175-pound senior, 36 tackles, 2 interceptions for the year. And the strong safety is going to be Nate Mary. Nate Mary with 35 tackles for the year, 5'8", 155-pound senior. So, it's King and Woods, the corners. Morgan and Mary are the safeties. Back from Shepherd right after this.
Check off your to-do list with big savings on building materials at Kane True Value. Kane True Value is your one-stop shop for building materials for those large-scale jobs, small projects, and everything in between. Whether you're building a house, adding on, or just updating, they carry the concrete, drywall, lumber, insulation, roofing, siding and molding, and many more products that you'll need. Add character and charm to your home with their large selection of paint colors. We have all the products that you'll need. Kane True Value. Behind every project is a true value.
Every team knows that a 2-point play could be a winning move. That's why our team at Tate Barber State Farm are here to help you go for two by combining your home and auto insurance. It's a great call that saves you time and saves you money. So go for the win and score savings by combining your home and auto. It's just another way that we're here to help life go right. Call us at Tate Barber State Farm, 903-693-7555.
Bauer Furniture Company says, get your home ready for the holidays. Bauer Furniture in Carthage, Texas has been locally owned by the same family for two generations. Their showroom offers 20,000 square feet filled with furniture for immediate free delivery. They offer America's number one recliner, that's Lazy Boy. They offer America's number one mattress, that's Serta. Do you need a new rug? They've got them. Do you need bar stools? They've got them. Bauer Furniture on West Panola in Carthage. Paul says, God bless America.
Panola County relies on UT Health Carthage for high-quality care from medical professionals you know and trust. We offer a full range of services like 24-hour emergency and level 4 trauma care, diagnostics including 64-slice CT, MRI, digital mammography, bone density, ultrasound, and X-ray, and UT Health First Physicians Clinics with specialists in obstetrics and family health. UT Health is proud to be one with East Texas and with the Carthage Bulldogs.
As you watch this ball game, if you look over at the Bulldog bench and you think, my goodness, that looks like a bunch of players over there, that's because there were no junior high, JV, or freshman games this week. So, in other words, Coach Surratt brought 71 players, 71 suited up tonight as compared to 25 for Shepherd. If you're wondering why we're playing on Thursday night, Coach Surratt told you on one of our interviews it's because if we're played tomorrow night, Shepherd would not have enough players to field a team because of grades coming out. All right, Mario, if you would, just to give everyone a flavor of where we are, get a picture of the visitor stands over there for us, okay? Again, we're coming to you from Pirate Stadium here in Shepherd, Texas. Alongside me, Mark Harris.
Yeah, Larry, if you've not come down 59 in a while to Houston, you would be really surprised at the construction going on, especially in Nacogdoches area, in the south part of the Nacogdoches Loop. And as we came on down, there was just all kinds of construction going on, preparing, I guess, for I-69 in the future. Tonight, we're playing a team that just had a rough season. The school district's had a rough time. And tonight, we're going to probably see a lot of our backups. Hopefully, we get to see the sophomores quite a bit tonight play. And, you know, I've talked to one of the coaches from Shepherd, and he said, we've got kids roaming the hall that are huge, that it could be offensive linemen. We have great athleticism that are not playing. And the reason the Carthage Bulldogs are a winning tradition is because they start from ground up, and the feeling is winning. And if you get a winning season, you'll get a lot more kids out. But y'all sit back and enjoy. I know there's very few people from Carthage here because of such a good distance here. And so we're going to bring it to you live, and you can watch it, as Larry says. And I hope we provide you the great play-by-play on the ball game. We'll be back right after this.
Quick Stop Carthage is your quick stop for anything you might need for running errands around the area or starting a road trip. Every day, 5 a.m. till 9 p.m., you can count on Quick Stop Carthage to have quality fuel and service items for your vehicle and something easy, fast, and tasty from the kitchen for breakfast, lunch, or supper. A specialty is one of the best hamburgers in East Texas. Your best stop 7 days a week in Carthage at 2365 Southeast Loop is Quick Stop.
Well, the Dogs are on the prowl again this year for yet another state championship. Carthage Missionary Baptist Church stand behind our kids 100% in the classroom and on the playing field. We urge them to do their best in life, to live their life for Christ, but enjoy every day as young people and use their talents to play the best game they possibly can. This is Dr. Dale Reed, Pastor Carthage Missionary Baptist Church, and go Dogs.
Because you're a fan of fresh made just the way you like it pizza, you'll love Country Fresh Pizza Carthage. We make it, you bake it. From a 10-inch to a 16-inch, even gluten-free crust is offered at Country Fresh Pizza. The Farmer's Delight features six meats and six veggies. The Vegetable Garden with all the veggies. The Rise and Shine with eggs and cheddar. The Crafty Farmer to build your own. And even Alfredo Pizza. Call 903-631-0246 to order. 636 West Panola, the white building with the bright graphics. It's delicious. It's Country Fresh Pizza.
Again, as Mark said, this team has had a struggle this year. You have to feel for them. Again, if this game were tomorrow night, it would not be played because the Shepherd coach informed Coach Surratt. He asked Coach Surratt, would you mind playing on Thursday? Because if we play on Friday, I don't have enough players to field a team because of grades, the restriction. I think it's tomorrow at 3 o'clock. In other words, if you play a game before tomorrow at 3 o'clock, they can play. If it's after 3 o'clock, they can't. And they have some still in quarantine because of the virus. But they've had respectable years in the last couple of years. That last year they were 3-7, and in two years ago in 2018 they made the playoffs. They went 6-5, but this year they are 0-4 in district play, and they are going to, of course, finish 0-5, and they'll be in the basement, and they are 1-8 for the season. So it's been a tough year for the Shepherd Pirates. Again, we're coming to you live from Pirate Stadium in Shepherd, Texas. Obviously, for district games, the band does not go on the road, so the Bulldog Band is not here. Jerry will be able to describe to you the Shepherd Band. Is that going to be a core band, Jerry?
Yep. Yes, it will be.
Okay, all right. All right, we'll be back from Pirate Stadium right after this break for your Sports Beach Station.
Hope Community Medicine at Panola College's W.C. Smith Building. Office hours, 7 a.m. to 5 p.m. Monday through Thursday and 7 a.m. to 3 p.m. on Friday. To schedule an appointment, call 903-690-8395. That's 903-690-8395. They offer quality health care based on income and household size through their slide fee scale. Hope Community Medicine in Carthage.
Max Flow Chemicals of Texas is second to none for service and treatment of saltwater disposal wells. Founded in 2011 in Carthage, Max Flow's experience and dedication to service with a proven chemical program sets it apart from competitors, which includes absolute customer satisfaction at the lowest possible cost. Get an in-depth evaluation of your system for a phone call, 903-693-4600, or an email at maxflowchemicals.com. Take your disposal well's performance to the max. Max Flow Chemicals of Texas.
Carthage Independent School District is where champions are educated. This school year is unlike any other, and CISD is rising to meet the needs of our students and community in ways like never before. Our teachers are providing stellar instruction for students both in person and virtually. We're utilizing a new and improved website to share vital information with students and parents. Help desks are in place at each campus to provide extra assistance for students navigating at-home learning. Our support professionals, principals, and central office staff are on hand to provide extra support for all Bulldogs. During these difficult times, Carthage ISD is here to help our Bulldogs continue being champions. Go Dogs!
Your KGIS broadcast crew coming to you live from Pirate Stadium in Shepherd, Texas. This is the final regular season game, and if the Bulldogs win this one, that means that the Bulldog seniors will have experienced four straight years of undefeated regular seasons. The Bulldogs own a 41-game regular season winning streak. They are 63-1 in their last 64 games. They've won championships in three of the last 4 years. Quite a run for this particular senior group. All right, we have the flags being brought out to the middle of the field, and we're going to have the national anthem coming up next, and right after that will be the coin toss. And let's see who's going to perform the anthem for us. Is it going to be the band, Jerry?
Yep, Shepherd Band is over to our left on the track.
Okay.
Please remove your headgear as we pay respect to our national colors posted in midfield during the playing of the national anthem by the pride of San Jacinto County, your Shepherd High School Royal Blue Band.
That's the national anthem played by the Shepherd High School Band. Oh, to our left on the track, eight-lane track here, and they are socially distanced over there because of the virus. And again, we are getting ready now for the coin toss. The coin toss brought to you by the Pony Express, located on West Panola, across from Panola College. They have lunch specials and a super salad bar and fuel for the car. Stop by before and after the home football games at the Pony Express, again on West Panola, across from Panola College. A little bit later, we'll talk to you about the playoffs coming up and tell you about all of the teams in our district. And again, the Bulldogs here for the final regular season game of the year.
Might point out that our sideline mic, Jason, is under the weather, and we want to wish him a speedy recovery. But Mark will make it down, I hope, at the end of the ball game to get an interview. But our halftime interview, we probably will not have.
All right. Again, that's Jason not with us tonight. He regularly roams the sideline with our Ford XL or XL Ford sideline mic. And the Bulldogs, all right, they've already had the coin toss.
They must have.
Must have had it before the teams came out, because we didn't. They didn't meet at the captains did not meet at the middle of the field. Getting started here at 6:30 because of everyone needing to get back to school tomorrow on Friday. All right, let's see. Back for the Bulldogs should be Cavante Brown Hoskins and also Javarian Rockmore. And again, we are playing here on a grass field.
Maybe Patty back here. Looks like Noah
could
Patty.
Be. All right, so here's the kick, and it's going to be taken at our 38-yard line to the 40, 45. So it's a line drive kick, one hop, taken by our up guy at the 38-yard line, and he returns it 8 yards to the 46.
That's Freddie Lynch who got that. Made about 5 yards. Freddie has really turned out to be a really good ball player for us this year.
All right, so Lynch returns it to the 46, a return there of 8 yards to the third from the 38 to the 46, and the Bulldogs come out first down and 10 at their own 46-yard line. The ball spotted 3 yards to the right of the left hash, and Kai Horton is going to go into the shotgun for this first snap. He's got Courtney with him to his left in the backfield, two receivers split out to the right and one to the left. Again, Horton in the shotgun, 6 seconds on the play clock. Now he sends McNew in motion. McNew sets up over on the right side. All right, here's Horton looking to throw. Great protection. Goes over the middle. This ball is off the hands of McNew for an incomplete pass. Second and 10.
That was a little bit too much juice by Kai right there. He had him open coming across the field and just threw it over his head, and McNew barely tipped it as it come across.
So second down and 10 for Carthage from their own 46. Again, Kai Horton hoping to set a new Carthage Bulldog record for a quarterback percentage completion in 1 year, 71.3 coming into the ball game. He sends three receivers to the right, tight end left, snap back to Horton. Horton throws right. This ball is caught out there by Brown Hoskins to midfield, 45-40, 35-30, still on his feet, down to the 25-yard line. Big house AC and electrical first down on the pass to Cavante Brown Hoskins.
Threw it real fast out to the outside and let him use his athletic ability to go down the right side of the field. It looked like he was face masked to me at one point, but he got out of it. Good game, good throw.
So 31 yards to Cavante Brown Hoskins. And Carthage has it now first and 10 at the Shepherd 23-yard line. First and 10 at the 23. If you've just joined us, Carthage won the toss. They took the football, took the kickoff. They elected to receive. And they've just picked up a first down on a 31-yard pass to Brown Hoskins. Okay, Horton now in the shotgun again. Two receivers to each side. Horton with going to throw right into the end zone. This ball is caught for a touchdown to Zay Woods. Woods for the touchdown. It is a Kane Hardware Bulldog touchdown of 23 yards.
Just a go route down the right-hand side and met him in stride about the goal line. Great throw. Wasn't much air under it. Pretty straight throw there by Kai Horton. Also, Kai is probably trying to go after a record of not losing a ball game as quarterback, too.
Doesn't Correct. He? That's right.
Kelly Red Zone on that as well.
Okay, here's Jimenez in for the extra point. The hold by McNew, and it is up and good. 7-0 early in the going here after 55 seconds of play. We'll be back right after this.
Throughout Texas, Louisiana, and New Mexico, one of the largest independent oil field service companies is Pinergy, ranked number one in the United States for total number of wells drilled.
you'll likely recognize Pinergy Carthage top management, Randy Taylor, Brandon Taylor, Andy Snow, Justin Taylor, and Steve Nations. At the Austin corporate office, senior management offers a combined 400 years experience regarding energy services. No more. Check the website, Pinergy.com, or call 903-693-8400. Pinergy.
All right, we don't want to ignore this. Okay, my fault for forgetting this. The first half kickoff, the Popcorn Place. Popcorn Place, thanks very much. Flowers, popcorn, or candy, the Popcorn Place is the place for all your Carthage High School homecoming needs. That Kane Hardware Bulldog touchdown, a 23-yard pass to Zay Woods, and the Bulldog stop extra point good by Irvin Jimenez. All right, we're getting ready to kick off. This is going to be Dawson Smith. He's the deep kicker. He has the strongest leg on the team. This kick is a high one, and it is going to go into the end zone, a couple yards into the end zone on the fly by Dawson Smith, and that would be a touchback. Shepherd will have the football.
Yeah, that's a great kick right there. We've got a variety of kickers. Well, Larry says we have eight at different times, and one of them's good for the pooch kick, one of them's good for the deep kick, and he's good for the deep kick.
Incidentally, four of those eight kickers, four different kickers last week kicked extra points, and they were the special teams MVPs, the four of them collectively. All right, so now let's see. This is Shepherd coming out, and they're going to be in the shotgun. I was not able to get starters from them. They weren't for sure who they were going to start because of the virus. They hand off to the running back, and the running back picks up maybe a yard to the 26-yard line. It'll be second and nine.
Yeah, Kylan Lister just smothered him there at the line of scrimmage. He fell forward for a yard or yard and a half.
So, second down and nine now for the Shepherd Pirates. Shepherd in blue uniforms with blue numbers.
Looks like number nine.
Trimmed in white.
I don't know if you have a roster, but looks like number nine is the quarterback.
Okay, if that's the case, it is Devin Wyatt. So, Wyatt this time hands off to the running back again, and he's hitting the backfield, and this is going to be – he may have gotten back to the line of scrimmage. They will give him the line of scrimmage, so it will be – third down and nine coming up. And incidentally, Coach Surratt again bringing 71 players tonight. About 10 of them are sophomores, and there's one freshman. And I want to call out his name because this is quite an honor. He's the only freshman brought for this ball game. That's Kydarius Matlock. Kydarius Matlock, the freshman, and about 10 sophomores. Again, 71 Bulldogs suited up tonight, 25 for the Shepherd Pirates.
Kylan Lister was the one also made the tackle then.
Third down and nine now for Shepherd. And here's the quarterback, and he's going to keep it himself, and he picks up 2 yards to the 28. And so that will bring up now fourth down and seven for the Shepherd Pirates from their own 28-yard line.
Brandon King made the tackle there after really very short game here. McNew is back deep.
So they're going to kick it, and evidently they are. Let's see. The kicker, I think, is over at the sideline talking to the coach. That is correct. Plenty of time still left on the play clock.
Number 23.
Okay.
Larry.
And that is Bryce Major.
Bryce Major.
Okay. And he only takes about a 10-yard drop. That's not much. Blocked. It's blocked. It is blocked. The ball is on the ground at the 15-yard line, and it's still on the ground. We'll get it one way or the other. It does not matter that they recover. It'll be Carthage football back at the Shepherd 11-yard line. It was blocked.
Kip Lewis blocked.
Kip Lewis got it? Okay.
Kip came through the middle and just disrupted the whole play. The blocker kind of blocked him into the play.
And, again, remember, as I mentioned before, the punt, they took a 9-yard drop. Usually, what's the usual drop? 15 yards. But they took a 9-yard drop, and it was blocked by Kip Lewis. A couple of players tried to pick it up, could not, and it's going to be at the 12-yard line. So Carthage first down and 10 now, second possession.
Time to get Courtney in the game here.
And they have it at the 12-yard line. Bulldogs on their first possession scored on three plays. All through the air. Snap back to Horton. Horton this time hand off Courtney. Courtney right side of the 10 to the 5. Courtney down toward the goal line. And he is going to be short of the goal line, but it will be a first down for the Bulldogs at the 1-yard line. So 11 yards for Courtney. Another house AC and electrical first down. And we are in the
Collision zone.
Right, there you go. The Kelly's collision red zone. There you go.
He cut. He handed the ball to the right. He had open territory, just drug down right before the end zone.
So picked up 11. All right, we've got I formation this time behind Horton. Horton under center. Tight end right. Pitch out Courtney. Courtney right side. Courtney goal line. Courtney touchdown. 1 yard run for Mason Courtney. So it's a Kane Hardware Bulldog touchdown of 1 yard for Mason Courtney. And the Bulldogs now lead it 13-0 here after 3 minutes and 35 seconds of play.
They just pitched it to the right, and he cut upfield about the tackle position and ran into the end zone. Was hit after he got into the end zone, but was never tackled.
We need a holder.
You sure do.
So,
you know, McNew's been holding, and so has Patty. Let's see who. That's McNew comes in. I guess you forgot.
All right, so the McNew's the holder. This is Madrano for the extra point. Good snap. The kick is away, straight, and it's good. Carthage leads it now 14-0 here in Shepherd. Back right after this.
If you need construction done, check with Carlos and Shane Courtney at Courtney Construction Incorporated. They're the best in the business, whether it's pipeline or dirt work, oil field maintenance, or general construction. The Courtneys are well experienced. Call them at 903-694-2911 or drop by 1300 Northeast Loop in Carthage. When you need it done right, call Courtney Construction Incorporated. They'll get it done.
Hey folks, it's Aaron Hicks with Elliott Dodge of Carthage. We are kicking off this football season with two great sales events, Ram Power Days and Jeep Adventure Days. This month at Elliott Dodge of Carthage, you can buy a brand new 2020 Ram 1500 at 0% for 72 months and make no payments for 90 days. You can also get the same offer on a new 2020 Jeep Grand Cherokee.
Okay, Dawson Smith again with the strongest leg of any kicker in the 14 years of Coach Surratt. Kicks off, here's a high kick. This one's going to go again into the end zone, just a foot or so into the end zone, and it will be a touchback. The Kane Hardware Bulldog touchdown that time, 1 yard by Mason Courtney, and the Bulldog stop extra point good by Madrano, and Carthage leads it 14-0. We've played 3 minutes and 35 seconds here in the first quarter.
Still all the starters in on defense. I'm sure we're going to have a flood of kids come in that we got to keep up with tonight. Like you said, number 28, Zakarian Tatum. Is starting. That's the first start he's had, I think.
That's his first one.
And he's come in a few times, you know, and really shine when he comes in. Kind of like Lynch. He earned a position.
All right. Now, Shepherd with the snap and the quarterback with a fake, and he keeps the football and nothing there, no gain at all. So it'll be second down and 10 coming up for the Pirates from their own 25-yard line. I would fully expect that sometime in the second half, maybe the entire second half, we'll have a running clock. Usually don't do that in the first half. Expect to see the twos here at least in the first half for the Bulldogs. Second down and 10.
Jackson on the tackle there for the Bulldogs. No gain.
All right, so second and 10 now for the Pirates from their own 25. And here's handoff, the running back going to the right to 30, 35-yard line, and he's going to have a first down on that run. That's by far their best play of the night so far. They pick up 11,
and
first down, and
a flag
comes in.
We have some late extracurricular activity there. That was a good play by them. They ran the ball up the right-hand side and got good yardage. Let's see what happens now. The flag came after the play was over with. And if it was one of us, I feel sorry for him going to the sideline. Because Coach doesn't put up with that. He's going to show us here.
I saw a lot of hand motion. I didn't recognize anything.
Yeah.
He's going. He's facing them. Looks like he's going to go. It's going to be against us. Looks like. He's talking to the coach over here.
Yes, yeah, that's not the best signals I've seen.
That's right, a big one.
That boy there likes
15 yards. 15 yards against Shepherd.
He biggies when he eats.
Okay, now the question is, was that okay, it's first down now and 10. So that happened after the play. That was a dead ball foul. So you give them the 11 yards, and it takes it back to the 21-yard line, and now they pick up 1 yard on this play.
Lewis on the tackle again. Him and Kylan Lister are in there showing out.
Yeah, I don't know where these officials are from, but just looking at the physique of the referee, we have not had this crew before this year. I can tell you that. Okay, so it's going to be second down and 9 now. Again, on that previous play, you give them 11 yards, the first down, and then the penalty comes after the play was over. Second and 9 now for Shepherd from their own 22. Second and 9. Dogs leading 14-0 in the first quarter here. Snap back to the quarterback. Hands off to the running back. Running back goes up the middle and picks up a yard or two. We'll give him one to the 23.
Kip Lewis again from the middle linebacker spot, just sticking his head in there and making the tackle.
So a yard to the 23, make it now third down and 8. Again, we're coming to you live from Shepherd, Texas, Pirate Stadium. Next week, by district round against the Gainesville Hornets, it'll be 7 o'clock on Friday night at Bruce Field in Athens. That's the home of the Athens Hornets, and also the Trinity Community College Cardinals play there too. Third down and 8.
If you don't know where Shepherd is, it's about 15, 20 minutes north of Cleveland. And about 5 minutes south of Goodrich, if you know, on your way to Houston.
All right, third down and 8 at the 23-yard line. And here's the quarterback, play action fake, throws right side. This ball is tipped and intercepted at the 25-20. This is Mary. Mary on the return, and he's down to the 20-yard line. It was picked by Nate Mary at the 35-yard line. He returns it 25 yards down to the 10-yard line.
It's somebody, and I think it was Lister, but I couldn't tell. Just stuck his paw up there, knocked it in the air, and it bounced right to our man, and he carried it back almost for a touchdown.
Nate Mary with the interception, and as Mark mentioned, it was deflected by one of the Pirates. So it's going to be first down and 10 for Carthage. I don't think it's first and goal. I think the football is just outside the 10-yard line. So it's first and 10. No, they're going to call it first and goal. First and goal right at the 10. Ball will be on the left hash this time. You've got Horton in the shotgun. Courtney to his left. Two receivers right, one left on the short side of the field. We await the snap. Shotgun snap. Horton play action fake. Throws over the middle. This ball is caught. Montrell Hatton with a Kane Hardware Bulldog touchdown of 10 yards, and it's 20-0.
He faked the ball to Courtney in the middle, drew the linebacker in, and threw it right over the outside where the linebacker would have been. And Hatton was running a down and in, or a post pattern, and he was wide open. Touchdown.
So Montrell Hatton with the extra, with the Kane Hardware Bulldog touchdown. Again, we're in the Kelly's Collision red zone here. And the extra point attempt now for the Bulldogs. And here is Garcia attempting it, and it is good. So the third different kicker for the Bulldogs. And we're 3-for-3 on extra points. It's 21-0, 5:46 to play in the first.
How's air conditioning and electrical?
Is Spider-Man there?
Well, I don't know where you can find Spider-Man.
Don't you always have something for everyone?
Well, we can help everyone with heating, cooling, and electrical repair needs. We install new systems and whole home generators, too. We don't know where any superheroes are, but we always have super prices.
Super prices? I never heard of that, superhero.
Since 1974, we've got something for everyone. Hal's Air Conditioning and Electrical. Call 903-693-7451.
Larry, how many interceptions do we have so far this year? Do you know? Did you ask that question?
I did not get an answer on that. I know we've got to have 15 or more. Quite a year. But I did not find a team record for interceptions. There is an individual record, and that's 8 by Bri Bolton. All right, here's the kick by Dawson Smith. Another long one. This one's going to go a yard or two deep in the end zone. His third straight touchback again. According to Coach Surratt, the strongest leg he's seen at Carthage in his 14 years. Another touchback, Shepherd, at their own 25.
And I'm sure they were kicking it deep to keep them from returning it, because we don't want an injury here. You know, we're at the last game of the year. We've got the playoffs starting next week. Just kick it out of the end zone, let them start from scrimmage.
All right, so it's going to be first down and 10 for Shepherd at their own 25-yard line. All right, in the shotgun again. Snap back to the quarterback. Hands off to the running back. Running back stopped in the backfield. This will be a 2-yard loss back to the 23.
And that was number 20, Jackson, on the tackle. He came in and had him behind the line of scrimmage. Good play by Jackson.
Be sure and stay with us at halftime. We're midway through the first quarter. Jerry will describe the core band from Shepherd. You think Mr. Wink's going to climb up the ladder, Jerry?
Well, I hope he does.
He loves the mic. He'll be here.
Oh, okay.
I climbed up the ladder
twice.
Yes, you did. Yeah,
twice.
Jerry, really proud of you. Yeah. Wanda, you should have seen him. I'm telling you, he was light on his feet there, I tell you.
Okay,
but out of breath. All right, second down and 12. This is dropped by the quarterback, and let's see. We've got play being stopped. We've got a flag down, and this is going to be false start against Shepard. So that'll take it back to the 18.
I thought I've seen false starts three or four times in this game, and they have not caught it.
So that takes it back to the 18-yard line. So it goes from being second down and 8 to
21-0
and about 15 to go.
21-0 here with 4 minutes left in the first quarter.
Okay, it's at the 18-yard line, and they've got to get to it second down and 12. All right, here's the handoff going to the running back, going to the right, and he is across the 20 and out to the 23, so that's going to be a gain of 5 on the play.
Lewis and Foster on the tackle. Along with King, all three of them converged. He looked like he was stopped at the line of scrimmage, but he got free and got a positive territory out of it.
Okay, so now it's third down and 12. Third down and 12 at the 23. Third down and 12 at the 23-yard line. Okay, we've got 3:50 left to play here in the first quarter. Carthage leading 21-0. Third down and 12 for the Pirates. Snap back to the quarterback. He's going to run to this right. Oh, and he is pushed back as he gets to about the line of scrimmage. He hit a brick wall there. Mark will tell us in just a second who it was. No gain.
It was Foster and Lewis at the same time, and he looked like he had just, like he said, hit a brick wall. Not 1 inch did he get after he was hit.
All right, now they're going to punt it. And remember, the last time they took about a 9-yard drop, and we blocked it. So the line of scrimmage is a 23. Oh, this time he's going to take a 13-yard drop. Yep, 13-yard drop instead of 9. There's this waist-high snap. He gets off the kick. Pretty good kick. No one back deep for the Bulldogs. It hits at our 44 and is going to bounce once, twice, and it stays at the 44-yard line. So that will be a kick of 27 and 6. That'll be 33 yards on that punt.
That's the difference, Larry, in a grass field and a turf field, because it did not move. Bounced straight up and then straight back down.
Great point. And again, as best I can tell from my source that I sent this question to, and I think he's probably right, the first grass game for Carthage, first time on a grass field in 8 years. The last time was 2013 at Jasper and Huntington. All right, first and 10 for the Dogs now at their own 44, leading 21-0. 3 minutes left to play here in the first. Horton again in the shotgun, snap back to him, throws to the right. This ball is caught out there at the 40 to the 45, midfield, 45, 40, and he's going to be out of bounds. It's going to be a Howes AC first down. Who was that to,
Craig Mark? McNew. Okay. Threw it out to him, and he made a cut, got away from a guy, went down the sidelines. Larry, I remember that game at Huntington. Remember the press box at Huntington? We were a lot better team than Huntington.
I'll never forget the press box.
No, it was terrible.
Okay, so 15 yards that time to McNew. 15 to McNew. And it's now first down and 10 for the Bulldogs at the Pirate 41. At the Pirate 41. All right, he sends a man in motion to the right. Hand off Courtney. Courtney goes over the right side, and he is across the 40. And struggling for more yards, still on his feet as he pulls some of the Pirates with him, and he winds up picking up 6 yards on the play.
I think every one of them hit him in that play, it looked like to me, and he kept pushing forward. He got hit with about a 2-yard gain and then made it 5 more out of it with the guys all over.
So he picks up 6 on that play, goes to the 35-yard line. It's now second down for Carthage, second and 4 at the Pirate 35. 1:50 left to play here in the first. Carthage leading at 21-0. All right, a double tight end formation. Don't see this too often. Here's a play action fake. Horton rolling to his right. Throws wide open out there on the right side as a receiver. And he has a Howes AC first down. He caught it at the 30 and is down inside the 25-yard line.
I think that's Keontae Smith, a 15. Is
15, okay.
Keontae Smith, that's a new name, a new wrinkle.
So that is going to be a 12-yard gain to Keontae Smith. And another Howes AC and electrical first down. We are at the 23-yard line, so we're only 3 yards away from the Kelly's Collision red zone here. A minute 10 left to play here in the first quarter. Carthage leading 21-0 here at Shepherd. All right, Horton this time going to be under center. No, he's going to go back into the gun. Two receivers to the left, one to the short side right. Snap back to Horton. Horton this time looking left. He throws left. This ball is caught by McNew at the 30. Spins loose to the 25. He may be gone. 20, 15, 10, goal line. Touchdown to Craig McNew. It is a Kane Hardware Bulldog touchdown of 23 yards to Craig McNew.
He threw it out there in the flat on the left-hand side. He made a cut. The guy, and let the guy step by and then ran down the sidelines, was tackled as he went into the end zone. You know, he doesn't start, his name is a starter, but he's our leading receiver, isn't he, Larry?
Yes, he is.
He's all holding right here, too.
So let's see if this is our fourth different kicker.
I believe it is.
And it is. Fourth different kicker on extra points. This is the big foot right here. High snap, kick away, and, boy, he puts that one into orbit, and it is good. Four in a row for the Bulldog kickers. It's 28-0 here in Shepherd, 46 seconds to play in the first.
Pritchard and Abbott Incorporated are evaluating consultants. What does that mean? They appraise minerals, industrial, utility properties, and data services. From their evaluations of a net worth, fair taxes can be levied. Pritchard and Abbott Incorporated doing their part to be a good neighbor and helping our part of the world stay strong and solvent. Pritchard and Abbott Incorporated, evaluating consultants.
All right, we're back here at Shepherd, Texas, home of the Shepherd Pirates. The Kane Hardware Bulldog touchdown, 23-yard touchdown pass to Craig McNew, and the Bulldog stop extra point good by Dawson Smith, our fourth different kicker on extra points.
Well, where are you listening from tonight? I know it's a Thursday night, and hopefully people realize that Carthage played on Thursday, 903-692-3836.
The extra points by Jimenez, Madrano, Garcia, and Smith. Again, eight kickers on this team, and you can partially thank Bubba Watson, who is the boys' soccer coach, for that fact, because the soccer program has really increased significantly our number of kickers on the football squad. Okay, here's Dawson Smith with another kick. This one's going to be another long one right here, and it's going to go to the one and then into the end zone. Didn't quite make the end zone on the fly, very close, and Shepherd will be looking at their fourth touchback at the 25-yard line.
Just a little short that time. 1 foot, and then it bounced into the end zone.
All right, so let's see what the Hornets, no, what the Pirates do here. Again, they have one first down, and they have 19 yards total offense. Carthage looks like with 132 yards of total offense, and it's 28-0, and this could very well be the final play of the first quarter. Again, the last game of the regular season. This would be four straight undefeated seasons if we win this ball game. Okay, snap back to the quarterback, hands off to the running back, going to his right, wrapped up. That's going to be a loss of 1 yard on the play. It'll bring up second down and 11. And that will be the final play, I think, of the first quarter. They do not have to run a play if they don't want to.
Jackson and Lister together on the tackle on that time.
And let's see if they're going to run a play or just let it run out here. They don't have to run a play.
I don't think they are.
And so I think we're going to go to the second quarter. And Carthage leads this one here 28-0. We'll be back from Shepherd right after this.
There's nothing like football season in Texas. As the number one ranked bank by Forbes in 2012, Prosperity Bank wishes the number one ranked Carthage Bulldogs good luck as they begin their quest for another state championship. Prosperity Bank offers exceptional mortgage rates, low auto and commercial rates, along with a variety of deposit products including online banking and now mobile banking too. With over 200 locations across Texas, Prosperity Bank can meet all your banking needs just about anytime, anywhere. Go Bulldogs, all the way to another state championship. Prosperity Bank, member FDIC, equal housing lender.
This is Baylor Bardwell with XL Ford. Hunting season is here, and we have our sight aimed on saving you money with our lineup of quality pre-owned cars, trucks, and SUVs. You don't have to have the patience of a hunter to bag one. Come into XL Ford now and let our friendly team find the right vehicle for your budget. Their knowledge and experience, backed by our reliable service department, are sure to please. Excellent prices, excellent selection, and excellent service at XL Ford or on the net at xlford.net.
All right, we return here to Pirate Stadium in Shepherd, Texas for Bulldog football.
They're listening to us from Nashville, Arkansas, also Julian, West Virginia.
Wow.
That's a wild one. And then Coach Watson's dad is in Texarkana. He's came in quite a few times. I hadn't mentioned his name, but I did tonight, Coach.
And usually, now, I don't know if they ever get in touch with you, Mark, but some of the Surratt family usually is listening. Okay, second down and 11 here. Here's a handoff to the running back. He goes straight ahead. And the line of scrimmage was the 24. And it looks like he's going to get the 28. So a gain of 4 yards there. Incidentally, to give you more of a feel for what we have here, just beyond the on the other side of the visitor stands, that's their baseball field. And behind us and to our right is the softball field.
We have a timeout on the
okay.
field.
Okay, now we'll take a break.
First State Bank and Trust knows evolving 21st century banking makes it important to have a financial partner who ensures the monetary services you need and want are available and accessible through technology. Checking and saving accounts, personal debit and credit cards, auto, home, and personal loans are connected through internet and mobile applications and contact with people when you need it. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender, 110 West Spinola, Carthage, 903-693-6606, fsbcarthage.com.
Well, we got one of ours and one of theirs, looks like.
Yes, we've got the softball field behind us and to our right, and the baseball field is behind the visitor stand.
Talk about who's listed to us. Amber and Summer's dad, Mr. Switzer, would listen to us regular, and he said he'd have 10 people over listen to the Carthage Bulldogs play, and he'd call me during the week and talk to me about it. I think he's passed away now.
Well, Switzers, I hope y'all are listening tonight. You bet. Hope you are. Okay, this is going to be now third down and 7. Third and 7 for the Shepherd Pirates at their own 28-yard line. Snap back to the quarterback, and he goes up the middle, and he's got some yards this time. He's got another first down, I believe. I believe he's got one. Yes, he does. It'll be an 8-yard gain out to the 36-yard line. First and 10 for the Pirates.
Morgan on the tackle from the safety position. So you know he got into the back, our backfield.
Tackled by number 5, Kip Lewis.
All right, so now it's first and 10 for Shepherd. Again, at their own 36-yard line. If next week starts the playoffs, hopefully the first of 6 ball games heading toward AT&T Stadium. And if you want to join us next week, we hope you can join us over at Athens, 7 o'clock, Bruce Field in Athens, against the Gatesville Hornets. All right, here's the snap back to the quarterback, and he goes left and is stopped pretty much right at the line of scrimmage. It'll be second down and 10.
Kip Lewis. Of course, Kip was in on the last tackle, too, but he's everywhere. And that's what the defensive line is supposed to do, let him roam, and that's what he's doing.
Gatesville is the number 4 seed. Remember, in the opening round of the playoffs, number 1 meets number 4, number 2 meets number 3. And so Gatesville is the number 4 seed out of District 9-4A. That district was won by Salado, one of the top 10 state-ranked teams in Class 4A Division 2. We probably will see the Salado Eagles in Round 3. Okay, we'll talk more about the playoffs a little bit later. All right, second down for the Pirates. Second, and here's the handoff, and going to be a gain of a couple yards out to the 38-yard line. So that's going to make it now third down and 8
Foster.
For Shepherd.
Foster came up out of that pile.
Tackled by number 6, Camden Foster.
We're 28-0 here in Shepherd, Texas. You're listening to us from Nash, Texas, which is right out of Texas County, I think. Forney, Texas.
Brings up third down at about 8.
Stacy Surratt is up there somewhere in that Texarkana area, I think. One of Scott's brothers. And Stan Surratt, the superintendent over at Lindale, could be listening. Not many games being played tonight. Okay, here's the handoff to the running back, and he is stopped for no gain at the 38-yard line. So that's going to bring up fourth down now for Shepherd. And we're probably going to see their second punt of the night.
They got another kid down. We'll go back. We'll be back right after this.
Hi, this is Monty Pierce, pastor at Central Baptist Church. We're all aware that our country, and in fact our whole world, is under attack by an invisible virus, COVID-19. Well, there is another unseen force in our world just as devastating, if not more. We call it sin. Fortunately, there is a cure. His name is Jesus. We invite you to join us at Central Baptist as we seek to learn more about this God who loves us so much. On Sunday mornings, we have Bible study for all ages at 9:30, and the worship service begins at 10:45. If you can't join us in person, we are live on KGAS AM and FM on cable channel 18, as well as Facebook Live and YouTube.
All right, so the young man, the player for the Shepherd Pirates, coming off the field is fourth down and 8. And the line of scrimmage is the 38-yard line, so it looks like they're going to be punting here.
River Hill, New York is listening to us.
And I told you they could hear us in New York City.
And this time they're going to take, they're going to take a 13-yard drop this time also. No, the punter will make it 12 yards.
Back to punt.
They get someone in there late. And that's going to be either delay of game. No, they're going to take a timeout. To avoid the delay penalty, they take a timeout. Shepherd timeout.
Carthage Flower Shop, located on the square in downtown Carthage, where they carry an array of fresh flowers and silk pot plants. Carthage Flower Shop also carries Colonial Candles, Mantra Bands, Hickory Farms, The Naked Bee, and Willow Tree Angels. Shop Carthage Flower Shop. They will help you with all your floral needs.
River Hill, New York, Larry, is 15 miles on the other side of New York, on the Atlantic. And that's Kai Horton's folks listening to us.
All right.
One of them.
Okay. So now the Pirates are ready to kick. And again, taking a 12-yard drop. Remember, the first one was blocked. Here's a waist-high snap. Gets off the kick. And no one back for the Bulldogs. And it's going to hit at the 37 and roll dead at about the 34-yard line. So that will be 12 is a 28-yard kick. And Carthage will have their football at the 34-yard line.
We got new blood coming
in,
Larry.
Yeah, we got new ones.
Our number 72 is Juan Perez, is a lineman. Also 65, is that 65?
Okay, Blake Strong is one of them.
65. Austin Grimes.
Okay.
Okay, Mark Moore's coming at quarterback.
Okay, so Rockmore is the quarterback here. Javarian Rockmore in the pistol. Hands off to the tailback. And he's going to be stopped after pretty much no gain. See if you can find out who that was, Mark.
I think it's Johnson, number 32, I believe. Let me see if he comes out of that pile. Can't really see. They're all together. I think it is Johnson. He's number 32.
32, you think so?
Tavarius Johnson, yes.
Okay.
Also, Noah Patty's in the ball game. Number 71 is a lineman. He's in the ball game. That's Blake Strong. You mentioned him a while ago.
Okay, so that was a 2-yard loss for Tavarius Johnson. Again, Rockmore, the quarterback, snap back to him, hand off to Johnson. Again, going left this time. And he's going to get some yardage this time, 35-40. And out close to another Howes AC first down. No, they're going to spot him back at the 41-yard line. So that's going to be a gain on the play of 9 yards for Tavarius Johnson.
He was fixed to break it. He got a shoestring tackle on the outside, but he had clear daylight in front of him.
Okay, give him 10 yards as they spot that one at the 42-yard line. So it's now third down and 2.
Jakarian Rockmore's in the ball game. I think that's Javoria's little brother.
So it's 3rd and 2 for the Bulldogs at their own 42. Snap back to Rockmore, handoff to Johnson. Johnson this time going left. Johnson wrapped up, and he's going to be a loss of 1 back to the 41.
And I'm sure we'll go for fourth down here.
Number 9,
that's number 66 coming into the game. Number 66 is Austin Graham. They're moving them in and out. Number 22, McCullough's in the ball game.
Again, the Bulldogs suiting up 71 players tonight, and it's the intent of Coach Surratt to get all 71, including one freshman that is suited up tonight.
Trokel is also the center, I believe, in the game.
Okay, right. So it's 4th down and 3 for Carthage at their own 41. And this time, Rockmore on 4th and 3 is going to go under center.
I'd run it.
With a tight end right formation this time. Handoff goes to Johnson. Johnson, no, he's going to throw it. Rockmore is. Now he's being wrapped up, throws downfield. This ball is tipped and incomplete. Lucky it was not intercepted. It was a fake handoff to Johnson. And then Rockmore rolling to his left was cornered by two Pirates. And as he fell to the ground, he threw it. Dangerous pass. Almost picked off. Incomplete. Pirates hold.
One of the Pirates had him by the collar when he let go of it. He probably should have just kept it. Be fine. But he threw it and it was broke up. So there's no harm done.
So the incomplete pass gives it back to Shepherd now with 6:12 to play here in the first half.
Our defense is in the game. You know, we got to play these kids. We've got a playoff game next week. You know, we got third and fourth quarter to worry about. So these kids have got to get playing time. We just don't want them to be injured. 6:12 left in the half. 28-0 Carthage.
Remember, a grass field, and so obviously as opposed to a artificial turf field, which should have no flaws in the surface. There are flaws in the grass field, obviously, can be. Here's a handoff to the running back going left, and he is really freight-trained as he picks up 1 yard to the 40. He was hit hard there at the 40-yard line.
That was Marion Kip Lewis. Wow. That would be I'd hate to grab the ball if I was one of them right now. These boys are hitting.
So 2nd down and 9 now for the Pirates. Picked up a short yard there. 2nd and 9 for the Pirates at the Carthage 40-yard line. We've got 5:40 left to play here in the half. Carthage leading here in Shepherd by a score of 28-0. Next week, by district round, Friday night at Athens against Gatesville, the Gatesville Hornets. In the shotgun, we await the shotgun snap. They have two receivers to the left, and we've got a timeout called
Shepherd.
By Shepherd.
East Texas is a wonderful community, and at Panola National Bank, we're proud to call it home. That's why you'll find our bank and our employees helping others wherever you look. From supporting local schools to volunteering with local charity events, we're part of the fabric that weaves the community and its people together. When it comes to financial service needs, local is better. We provide convenient banking services so we can help our community grow. Panola National Bank, member FDIC and an equal housing lender.
At Carthage Furniture, Monty has chest freezers from 5 cubic feet for $239 to 9 cubic feet at $419, and all sizes and prices in between. At Carthage Furniture, find 110-volt window AC units starting at $349. They even have a 15,000 BTU window AC that will cool up to 3 rooms for only $549. Remember, Carthage Furniture offers free delivery. The U Store on West Panola, right behind the car wash, where Rosa speaks Spanish.
Coming to you live from Pirate Stadium in Shepherd, Texas. Carthage leading the Shepherd Pirates by a score of 28-0. We are in the second quarter, 5:23 left to play in the half, and the Pirates are facing 2nd down and 9 at the Carthage 40-yard line. They're going to send one receiver wide to the left, and he's standing out there waiting for the play. Everyone else is still in the Shepherd huddle. Now they break the huddle, come up to the line of scrimmage. Quarterback in the shotgun, snap back to him, hands off the running back going left this time, and he may have gotten a yard. I think he did get a yard. Yes, he did to the 39, then he's pushed back.
Yeah, that was Foster and Lewis, two linebackers converging right there together. And they also have a timeout. Kid's hurt. We'll see if they're going to go to – he's coming off the field.
Yeah, he had to come off because the helmet cut came off, and – he looks a little dazed as he comes off. Helmet came off, which means you have to come out, of course, for one play. That's a rule. So now it's going to be third down and about 8. 3rd and 8 for the Shepherd Pirates. That's the Gatesville Hornets that we play next week. Shepherd Pirates, third and eight at the Carthage 39. The ball spotted about 3 yards to the right of the left hash. They break the huddle and quickly up to the line of scrimmage and send a receiver to the right, wing right. Here's the quarterback. He's going to run with it up the middle, and he's got 2 or 3 yards. We'll give him the 36-yard line, so give him 3.
Jackson and Foster on the tackle. Also, there, I agree with this statement. Some guys listening from Fairplay, Texas, capital of Panola County. I agree with that. Also, they're listening to us from Flower Mound, Texas, so we're all over the place.
So it's now 4th down and 5. 4th and 5 for the Shepherd Pirates from the Carthage 36. 3:53 to play here in the first half. All right, Shepherd up to the line of scrimmage. They're going to send a receiver wide right. Snap back to the quarterback. He's going to go with a quarterback draw, and he's going to be stopped short. He needed 5 yards, and he gets 1, and Carthage holds on down, and they take over at their own 35-yard line.
And Lewis is having none of it. He's had numerous tackles tonight. Even the PA announcer's calling the name.
And remember, you can watch this again. Hope you're watching it live right now, but you can watch it again Monday at noon, Chalk Talk at the Fieldhouse. And if you haven't been in several years, you have to bring your own lunch if you want to eat, because they do not bring in food as they did for many years, okay? So bring your own food or eat before or after, whatever. Monday at noon at the Fieldhouse. All right, Rottmore again, the quarterback, 1st and 10 for the Bulldogs. He wants to throw it. Looking left, going deep left. Has a man out there. This ball is caught at
Patty.
The 30-yard line. He's going to score, and it's going to be Patty on the Kane Hardware Bulldog touchdown. And it goes for, let's see, that's going to be 66-yard touchdown pass to Noah Patty.
That was perfect throw. He ran right into it. He was wide open down the left sidelines. That was like almost like Horton-ish right there. That was perfect throw. They say the boy can throw the ball, and it just shows it right then.
So 66-yard pass, again, the Kane Hardware Bulldog touchdown to Noah Patty. Here's the extra point attempt, and it is up, and it is good once
49.
Again. And it's now 35-0 Carthage.
No reason to drive out of town to get an amazing deal on any new Chevrolet vehicle. We won't be undersold. Hello, East Texas. Will Blackwell here with Pippin Motor Company, and we're aggressively seeking your business. All Chevrolet vehicles are clearly marked on the vehicle, reduced on our website, and discounted right up front to eliminate any need of going out of town. We have researched our competitors and are certain you will save the most money right here at home. Come experience a better way to buy a vehicle right here at home. That's Pippin Motor Company, just across from Panola College, or online at pippinmotorcompany.com.
Well, Jerry, did you ever think when you bought KGAS years ago that somebody would be listening from Sasha, Japan, or New York City?
I really did not, no. But I'm excited that they are.
That's right.
Okay, the Kane Hardware Bulldog touchdown, 66-yard pass to Noah Patty and the extra point. And I did not catch who the kicker was.
29, number 29.
29, okay, that's our 5th different kicker. Maybe Coach Surratt's going to go with all 8 of them tonight. Who knows? All right, so it's going to be Dawson Smith, the strong leg, to kick off again for the Bulldogs. Here's his kick, and this one's a high one, and it's not going to be as deep. They're going to take it this time at the 7 on a fair catch. That'll bring it out to the 25-yard line, 1st and 10 Pirates.
Well, next week we'll go to Athens.
And number 7, Wyatt Johnson.
Gatesville team that we really, I don't remember us ever playing Gatesville, Larry.
Have not. That's located 30 miles west of Waco. So it's way down there in Central Texas. They defeated Gerald last week. That district is off this week. There are several districts that, because of the virus, they decided to have their off date in the final week. That way, if there's any games that were, you know, had the virus postponed, they could have a chance to make him up, I guess. All right, so here's the handoff. It goes to the running back going to his right, and he's going to have, 2 or 3 yards.
Jackson on the tackle.
Looks like he's to the 27, so we'll give him 2.
Also in the game is Ethan Kimberly. I have not called his name. Ethan Kimberly, number 34.
And I tell you, on that pass to Noah Patty, you could tell, you know, Coach Surratt has said that he's got the best speed on the team. You could tell it because he opened up some space between him and the guy on the defense for Jasper, I mean, for Shepherd.
You know, last year when we had Cavante, that's when they threw it, he separated. And that's what happened to Patty. He separated at that point.
All right, second and eight this time now from the 27. Here's a handoff to the running back going this time to the left. He's across the 30 after the 32. Jessica Big Gia, gain of five.
Kimberly on the tackle, also with Deontay Mary. Another Mary coming through.
So it's going to be now third and three for Shepherd at their own 32. Third and three.
A lot of new faces.
We got 2:15 to go.
Number 28, just like he's, of course, I've seen him play before, Jakarian Tatum. He started. I guess they're getting him some time. He used to the playoffs.
Third down and three for Shepherd at their own 32. Under 2 minutes to go now in the half. And there's a snap to the quarterback. Quarterback going up the middle, trying to get to the first down at the 35, and he will not make it. It's going to be a yard shy, so that's a gain of two on the play. And it will bring up now fourth and one for the Pirates from their own 34.
Javari Brown in on that tackle. We're going to be calling a lot of new names on these tackles.
So let's see if they go for it here on fourth down and one. 1:25 left to play and counting here in the first half. Carthage leading it 35-0 over the Shepherd Pirates. Boy, a lot of big games coming up tomorrow night in Class 4A. Two biggies, two district championship games. One is Pleasant Grove at Gilmer. All right, fourth down and one. Quarterback with a snap for the first down. He's got it. Okay, he picks up 2 yards, and they pick up a first down.
You know, Pleasant Grove lost their good lineman, their good ball player, Larry.
Right.
Dick Dixon for the year, broken leg.
Tackled by number 21, Shannon Reeves.
See how they respond in a tight game.
All right, so it's going to be first down and 10 now for Shepherd at their 37. First and 10 at the 37. And here's a handoff to the running back going to his left, and he is stopped for what looks like no gain there.
Kid came in the ballgame at the last second. Number 85, KD Bell, was on that tackle. Sophomore.
Number 7, Wyatt Johnson with the carry.
Okay, so no gain on the play.
Shannon Reeves with the tackle.
And we're now down to 10 seconds to go in the half. And let's see if they get this playoff.
Second down.
5, 4, 3, 2. Snapped it with one. Handoff running back going to his left. And he gets out to the 40. And he stopped there, a gain of 3. That's halftime. And the Carthage Bulldogs lead it here at half, 35-0. Remember, Jason Wade ill tonight, so we will not have an interview with Coach Scott Surratt. We will have one at the end of the ball game. But Jerry, be back with the Shepherd Band right after this from our Sports Beat Station.
We want you to join the winning team at Hudson Financial Group and let us assist you in finding the best game plan for your insurance and investment needs. We are licensed with over 30 companies to provide you with the best coverages and prices, whether you need personal, commercial, or life insurance. At HFG, we strive to prepare our clients for the unexpected and their future. Stop by our office at 1519 West Panola or give us a call at 903-693-7874 and let us help you with your winning game plan today. And go Dawgs!
Navigating 21st century business financial currents can be trying, even for seasoned commercial endeavors. Get assistance charting your course with trustworthy commercial lending officers at Farmers State Bank, Carthage Center, Joaquin, and Shelbyville. FSB offers 116 years stability, a finance source for expansion and equipment purchase to help ensure growth on the path you want. Committed to East Texas business long-term success, your commercial financial request decisions are made by officers you likely know already. FSBCTX.com, Farmers State Bank, member FDIC, equal housing lender.
Check off your to-do list with big savings on building materials at Kane True Value. Kane True Value is your one-stop shop for building materials for those large-scale jobs, small projects, and everything in between. Whether you're building a house, adding on, or just updating, they carry the concrete, drywall, lumber, insulation, roofing, siding, and molding, and many more products that you'll need. Add character and charm to your home with their large selection of paint colors. We have all the products that you'll need. Kane True Value. Behind every project is a true value.
Well, it's halftime here at Shepherd. Carthage Bulldogs, if you just join us, are leading 35-0 at halftime. Shepherd Pirate Band across the way.
Under the direction of Mrs. Holly Harrison and Mrs. Jada Gray, along with Social Director Mrs. Teresa Henry.
This is a core band. For our radio audience, the uniforms are blue, trimmed in white. They have a really tall white plume on their shako. Looks like they're going to have somewhere, band looks like, I'll check the number here in just a minute, but about 30, maybe 35 members. And we hear amplified music right now as the dance team comes out. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 young ladies. Their uniform very similar to the uniform of the Kilgore Rangerettes, except they don't wear, well, they do. They wear the Rangerette boot rather than the high top boot. Got a Western belt. It's a white leather belt. Two colors of blue on the uniform. The pom-poms that the young ladies are accenting their dance steps with are blue. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 young ladies out on the field. Right on the near hash mark.
Military officers tonight are Bonnie Pope, captain. Aralise Garcia, co-captain. Caitlin Harper, lieutenant. Hannah Dubois, lieutenant. And social officer not present tonight is Caitlin Pollard. Pirates Pride of the Week is Summer Owens. Pirates Pride will be performing a pom routine to celebrate.
The music, celebrate. Basic drill team step for our radio audience. Using the pom-poms to accent the music and the dance step. Contagion. And the dance line sets up into a chevron. From Shepherd, Texas, Pirate Drill Team.
Great job, girls.
And the young ladies will move off the field and the band prepares to come on. Now, for those in our viewing and listening audience, the traveling bands have not been coming. So we only have the home band. But I will remind you that the Battling Bulldog Band has an invitational marching contest in Carthage on Saturday. If you enjoy watching band competitions, this is invitational, as the bands will be preparing for the Region 21 marching competition.
The band is led on the field by Color Guard Captain Cadence Myers, brass captain Jeremiah Isbell.
And the competition for UIL Region 21 will be in Carthage, Texas, one of the few times that our home folks will have a chance to see the region competition. It'll be on November the 18th, and I don't have the schedule in front of me. I think Carthage Band marches somewhere around 6 o'clock, maybe it's 6:20, that they march on the 18th, which is a Wednesday night. Something different because normally the band's competition is on Saturday, and most of the time it's at Stephen F. Austin in Nacogdoches, Texas, but not this year. This year it will be in Carthage at Bulldog Stadium. And the reason for that is that we have the indoor facility in case of rain. We'll be talking a little bit more, too, about the National Military Marching Band Competition, which will be in Pine Tree this year. And it's an official UIL state competition for the first time. Looks like the band has about 24 members in the wind portion. The auxiliary have 1, 2, 3, 4 flags, and actually 5 in the auxiliary. They have a pit, melodic percussion. It looks like there's 1, 2, 3 members there. So the band's somewhere around 34, 35 members on the field. This is a core band. Turn your mic on.
Yeah, Jerry, I hear that the stadium at Pine Tree is awesome.
Oh, it's really a fantastic stadium. You bet it is.
Portion of the 2020 UIL competition show, El Matador. We hope you enjoy.
And the theme is the Matador, and this is their UIL competition theme. Drum major on the podium right at the 50-yard line. Let's go down and listen. Mark, you've got your mic on. You might notice that they have amplification. And for the core band, that's legal as long as a student playing whatever instrument is amplified.
Oh, okay.
And you have your melodic percussion. You see your xylophone down the way. And you have a keyboard. Then you have a set of cymbals in the pit. Now, the pit is the part that is not on the marching field.
That's what it's called?
Uh-huh. That's called the pit. Flag members are standing at the numbers here on the field at Shepherd. And now they have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 flag members. And it looks like we have 3 young ladies and 2 men out on the field as part of the flag group, the flag auxiliary. The uniform now for the Shepherd Band, the Pirate Band, black shoes, black trousers. The coat is blue, and it's got that military glove on it. There's a word for it, and it escapes me right now, but it kind of looks like a Western-style glove. One other thing, they wear a West Point-style shako. However, the plume is about twice, normally about a 6 to 8 inch plume. That's looks like it's a 12 inch plume or better. Really a tall plume, which is something that we don't normally see up in the East Texas area. Something a little different too, they've got the tuned percussion out on the field at the very back of the band. A lot of times you see those percussion members floating from position to position. We just finished the Region 4 marching competition. in Sulphur Springs last Tuesday, all the 3As in that area, which is north of I-20. And we saw, what we observed is, because of the pandemic, a lot of bands played really, really well, but may have had a mistake or two out on the field because they haven't had that time, nor the crowd, with the bands not traveling.
Right.
You know, you don't get that nervousness that you need to have in front of a crowd sometimes.
Well, plus, you know, that's practice too. Yep. Every time you do a game, you're really practicing also
for
a contest later. And so I'd be feel sorry kind of for the bands because they're going into this kind of blind. They haven't really done a whole lot of field marching. I know they have at home.
Saw some really good. Now, we talk about core bands. The best military band that I saw, there were two, New Diana and White Oak. Both of those were just outstanding. White Oak Band marched right at 160-something students, but Mineola and Queen City.
Queen City.
Queen City in Mineola in the core style would have impressed anybody anywhere. You know, and I have to say now, core is not necessarily my thing, but those two bands made a first division. It would have been a first division at anybody's contest. They just did a super, super job. So, and we have that, by the way. It is archived, and you can go to easttexastoday.com if you'd like to see those bands and call them up and look at them in the archive position. What is the correct way to say that? I need words. But you can go back and see that competition and see what a really good core band looks like. You can see what some good military bands look like. James Ford is band director over at New Diana and just did a super, super job. And Mr. Steele is band director at White Oak. Mr. Steele's mother was in that White Oak band that went to the Tournament of Roses parade.
Wow.
Yeah, I had the pleasure of being the director of that band. Mr. Steele's mother is a twin, and her brother played first trumpet. She played clarinet. But anyway, all right, Larry, I'll give you a chance to get some stats. We're going to play some commercials real quick, and then we'll let you kind of bring us up to date. Got plenty of time. My machine here decided to do something that I wasn't prepared for it to do.
Went to that marching contest, looks like to me.
Yeah, it did, didn't it? Let's see what happened.
21st century business financial currents can be trying, even for seasoned commercial endeavors. Get assistance charting your course with trustworthy commercial lending officers at Farmers State Bank, Carthage Center, Joaquin and
Shelby. Thought you'd appreciate this commercial.
116 years stability,
it's the best one.
Source for expansion and equipment purchase to help ensure
in
growth
on
the path you want. Committed to East Texas business long-term success, your commercial financial request decisions are made by officers you likely know already. FSBCTX.com, Farmers State Bank, member FDIC, equal housing lender.
A lot of talent there.
This next commercial is for a person that had a birthday. He turned the big 5-0.
Check off your to-do list with big savings on building materials at Kane True Value.
Kane
True Value is your one-stop shop for building materials for those large-scale jobs, small projects, and everything in between. Whether you're building a house, adding on, or just updating, they carry the concrete, drywall, lumber, insulation, roofing, siding, and molding, and many more products that you'll need. Add character and charm to your home with their large selection of paint colors. We have all the products that you'll need. Kane True Value. Behind every project is a true value.
Paul didn't have a birthday. Paul Kane didn't have a birthday.
Every
Tate
team
Barber
knows
did.
That a two-point play could be a winning move. That's why our
thought
team
he was 60.
At Tate Barber State Farm are here to help you go for two by combining your home and auto insurance. It's a great call that saves you time and saves you money. So go for the win and score savings by combining your home and auto. It's just another way that we're here to help life go right. Call us at Tate Barber State Farm, 903-693-7555.
Okay, Larry, have you got some stats for us?
Yes, I do. Okay, the stats are brought to you by the First United Methodist Church. They invite you to join them each Sunday morning to hear their pastor, Kevin Otto, First United Methodist Church with the stats, and here we go. First downs, Carthage with 9, Shepherd with 3. On the ground, Carthage 25 yards, Shepherd 51. Through the air, Carthage 7 of 9 for 180. Shepard, 0 for 1. They attempted one pass, incomplete, so no yards passing for Shepard. Total yards, Carthage 205, Shepard 51. Turnovers, Carthage with none. Shepard had one. Penalties, Shepard punted last twice for 20 yards. And punts, Shepard punted twice for 31 yards. Here's the scoring in the first half. 23-yard pass to Zay Woods. A 1-yard Mason Courtney run. 10-yard pass to Montrell Hatton. 23-yard pass to Craig McNew. And a 66-yard pass to Noah Patty. And 5 for 5 on extra points by 4 different kickers. Irvin Jimenez with 2 of them. Medrano had 1. Pedro Garcia 1. And Dawson Smith with 1. And it's 35-0 Carthage. Okay, we're going to come back and take a quick look at the playoff picture right after this from KGAS.
Bauer Furniture Company says, get your home ready for the holidays. Bauer Furniture in Carthage, Texas has been locally owned by the same family for 2 generations. Their showroom offers 20,000 square feet filled with furniture for immediate free delivery. They offer America's number one recliner, that's Lazy Boy. They offer America's number one mattress, that's Serta. Do you need a new rug? They've got them. Do you need bar stools? They've got them. Bauer Furniture on West Panola in Carthage. Paul says, God bless America.
Panola County relies on UT Health Carthage for high-quality care from medical professionals you know and trust. We offer a full range of services like 24-hour emergency and level 4 trauma care, diagnostics including 64-slice CT, MRI, digital mammography, bone density, ultrasound, and X-ray, and UT Health First Physicians Clinics with specialists in obstetrics and family health. UT Health is proud to be one with East Texas and with the Carthage Bulldogs.
Okay, Larry.
All right, let's take a look at the playoffs. Class 4A Division 2 is divided up into 4 regions, 4 districts in each region. The districts in our region are 9, 10, that's us, 11, and 12. And so you have 8 teams going into a 3-week tournament, so to speak. And here are those 8 teams. Okay, one of the teams is going to be the winner out of 9. That's going to be Salado. Salado, I'm going to say that incidentally, in our district, Carthage is number 1 seed. Jasper's playing Madisonville tonight. Jasper's number 2. Center and Rusk are tied. Tomorrow night, Center and Rusk will play each other. The winner gets 3 seed. The loser gets 4. So I'm going to say that Center's going to win that ball game and be the number 3 seed. Rusk will be number 4. So in the opening round next week, Salado will play Rusk. All right, the winner of that one, which should be Salado, will get the winner of Belleville, the runner-up in 12, and either Orangeville or Hardin-Jefferson. Orangeville and Hardin-Jefferson are tied up in District 11 for third place. The winner gets third and the loser gets fourth. All right, then Carthage, the winner of 10, we will face the fourth seed in District 9, which is Gatesville. And then the winner of that one, which, of course, should be the Bulldogs, the following week we'll get the winner of Silsby next week going up against Lamarck. Silsby is the runner-up in 11. They are the runner-up behind West Orange Stark, a real powerhouse in our region and the number 2 ranked team in Class 4A Division 2. So Silsby will go up against Lamarck. So if you say that Carthage will beat Gatesville, you say Silsby will beat Lamarck, then that means 2 weeks from tonight, second round of the playoffs, it'll be Carthage and Silsby. And Coach Surratt has already, I tell you what, it's tough to find stadiums, but he's found a great one. That game on November 20th will be played at SFA. That's 2 weeks from tonight, 2 weeks from tomorrow night, pardon me, on a Friday night. Silsby and Carthage, if Silsby can beat Lamarck.
Surprisingly, Larry, we haven't played a whole lot of games at SFA over the years, you know?
Have not. And incidentally, if you're thinking, well, what about Lufkin? Well, Lufkin is not hosting. They have said no playoff games they're going to host this year.
Good.
All right.
Let's see.
We are about ready for the kickoff, and so we will set it up here for you. The Bulldogs won the toss to start the ball game, and so that means that Shepard will get the kickoff here in the second half, and it'll be Dawson Smith. No, it's going to be Medrano. Okay, Medrano, remember, he's our pitch kick expert, specialist, and Coach Surratt calls it the sky kick. And remember, Coach Surratt, where does he want it? He wants it on the numbers, and he wants it between the 28 and the 32. And so let's see if Medrano practices the sky pooch kick right here. Again, he's not the guy to that usually kicks it deep. It's usually the pooch. Let's see what he does right here. He's getting ready to start. Second half, Carthage leading 35-0, and here he advances on the ball, and here, oh, he's going to go deep with it. Okay, and they're going to take the fair catch at the 10-yard line. That brings it out to the 25.
Well, we'll see probably not a lot of new faces again that we haven't called all year. Now the offense comes in.
And the clock is running. Incidentally, that was a record first half. We got that first half over in about 47 minutes tonight, 47 to 50 minutes, something like that. And so the clock, is running right now. Ordinarily, it would be stopped.
K.D. Bell's the defensive lineman on the end.
All right, so here come the Shepherd Pirates up the line of scrimmage at their own 25-yard line. Snap back to the quarterback. He's going to go up the middle with it, and he's going to be pushed back. In fact, he doesn't go down. They just stand him up, and they're going to give him a 3-yard gain after the 28.
I can't really tell who made that tackle. It looked like all 11 Bulldogs were in there. A
lot of white jerseys.
Okay, let's see if we can get some of these
Number
guys.
Number 78, Devon Wallace is in the game.
How about 34, Ethan Kimberly? I think we missed him in the first half.
We did. He made a couple of tackles.
Who's that tall dude, number 22?
That's McCullough.
That's McCullough. Okay.
And look at number 25. That's a married kid. He's a big kid.
Yeah. Yeah, he is.
He's a sophomore. These kids are getting game time experience.
All right. So now it's second down for the Pirates. Second down and 7. And here's the quarterback. He's going to roll to his left. He wants to throw it. He throws it into the bench. Almost makes the first lane of the track. And that will bring up now third down and 7.
Javari Brown and Mary were in pressure, and he had to get rid of
it. Yeah, and again, the clock is running. It ordinarily would be stopped there on an incomplete pass. So we're going to get out of here. Boy, if Jerry has a heavy foot, we'll be home. We could be home by 9:45 tonight. No, it won't be that early, but we'll be out of here earlier than normal. Again, we are broadcasting from under the stars here in Shepherd, up on the roof of the press box. Third down and 7 for the Pirates. And here's handoff, running back going to his left, wrapped up for a loss. That's going to be a loss of 2 back to the 36.
Carrick Johnson on the tackle on that one.
And that'll bring up fourth down now. So it'll be fourth down, and I would think they would be punting. It'd be fourth down and 9.
Davian Wallace is in also on that tackle.
And again, we've never sent anyone back deep on the punts.
We don't want to risk an injury.
And so it will be a 13-yard drop for the punter as he takes his snap. We blocked one. There's the knee-high snap. He gets off the kick. No one's back deep. It's going to hit at the Carthage 48, and it's going to roll dead, be picked up at the 47. So that will be a 24-3, is 27-yard kick.
Yeah, we're going to get to see, I guess, Javorian quarterback in. Make it to see Cuff tonight, sophomore quarterback.
And they do stop the clock for the change of possession. Incidentally, according to Coach Surratt, all of our sub-varsity teams were district champs, including the 7th B and 8th B. And, of course, no games this week because Shepherd only fields a varsity team. That's it. First down and 10 now for the Bulldogs. And it is Rockmore in there at quarterback here now at our own 47-yard line. Handoff goes to number 19 going to the left. I think that's Delaney, midfield. And he's cut down at the Pirate 48-yard line. Is that Delaney, number 19? Who is that?
Number 19.
Demarion Delaney,
yeah.
Junior. Okay, so he picks up 5. 5 yards for Delaney.
Patty's in at wide out. Also number 48, it's his Todd Register, a sophomore. We're going to see a lot of sophomores this half.
Okay, so we'll give him 4. It's a 4-yard gain to the Pirate 49. In the pistol is Rockmore to take the snap. And handoff goes to the running back, the tailback. And let's see, he's going to be stopped for a loss. And was that Delaney
That's
again?
Number 21, 31.
31, who is that?
Let me get him a new guy. Oh, I can't even pronounce the name. Zema Williams, I think.
31. I got it. Zamad Williams.
Zamad, okay.
Zamad.
Sorry, Grandma. Zamad.
I had to ask my bride, who incidentally had a big birthday this past week, Larry.
Congratulations. Don't mention the number, Larry.
Let's put it this way. That first digit turned over. You can just think what that first digit change was. Okay, third down and 8 now. Okay, here's Rockmore wants to throw it. Throws it left. This ball is incomplete. Intended there for Delaney. Clock keeps moving. Oh, it should.
Well, they stopped it.
Yeah, they stopped it.
Number 77 is in the ball game. Christian Miller,
Now, the referee's going to look around. He's going to see it stopped. I thought he would start it up again.
Juan Perez.
I'm surprised at that.
It's been running, though.
It has been running. Okay, fourth down. Fourth down and 8 for Carthage at their own 49. And Carthage is going to go for it at our own 49-yard line. So it's Rockmore in the gun.
He's got a back to his left.
We've got twins to the left and one to the right. Here's Rockmore throwing right. This ball is caught there, and it's caught at the 40. 35.
There it goes.
It's gone, and this is going to be a touchdown by Patty. Another Kane Hardware touchdown pass to Noah Patty of 53 yards. Way to go, Noah Patty.
Threw the ball kind of on an end pattern, and then he made a cut and then took off the jets, and you could tell he's the fastest kid on the team.
53 yards to Noah Patty. So that's a Kane Hardware Bulldog touchdown again to Noah Patty.
That's over 100 yards receiving.
That's right. 119 yards for him tonight. Okay, and so we've got the extra point to come. This is Garcia holding it, it looks like. He's one of the kickers holding it for Madrano, and Madrano puts it inside the left upright. 42-0, Carthage, 7:15 to play in the third.
Quick Stop Carthage is your quick stop for anything you might need for running errands around the area or starting a road trip. Every day, 5 a.m. till 9 p.m., you can count on Quick Stop Carthage to have quality fuel and service items for your vehicle and something easy, fast, and tasty from the kitchen for breakfast, lunch, or supper. A specialty is one of the best hamburgers in East Texas. Your best stop 7 days a week in Carthage at 2365 Southeast Loop is Quick Stop.
And we did the red zone cross through.
Yes, we did.
Kelly's collision.
Okay, so the Kane Hardware Bulldog touchdown, a 53-yard pass from Javarian Rockmore to Noah Patty, and then the extra point, the Bulldog Shop extra point, was good by Madrano. Noah, I tell you what, he turned on the jets again that time and had separation after he caught the ball, just flat ran away from the Shepherd team. And another long touchdown pass reception for Noah Patty, 66 yards in the first half, 53 yards here in this half. All right, here I believe this is Dawson Smith. This one's going to go deep. It's going to hit at the 2 and into the end zone, another touchback. And we've got all touchbacks tonight by our kickers. And Shepherd will have a first and 10 at the 25-yard line. Look forward to calling Noah's in baseball, too. What's his position in baseball, Jerry?
Everything.
Shortstop, second base.
Okay, shortstop. All right.
I believe I'd have him lead off hitter.
Now, Rockmore is a great shortstop, too, but he's going to be one of our pitchers. I tell you what, we lost a great one. You know, Dylan Leach, a D1 recruit. Went to the University of Arkansas, graduated early, but we've got a lot of good ones coming back. Okay, here is a handoff to the running back, and he picks up about 3 yards to the 28-yard line.
It was number 21 on the tackle and number 26, number 21.
I tell you what, a key baseball player to get back and to have for the last, couple of rounds of the playoffs here would be Braden Wade. And we'll check next week with Coach Surratt, get his comments on the interview about Braden. He has, you know, a cast on his ankle, and it was not a complete – it was not – what's the word I'm looking for? It was not displaced, okay, which is good. It means no surgery. And so could be back for the third or fourth round. All right, here's the snap back to the quarterback. Quarterback going to keep it himself going right this time. And he has the 30-yard line. He has the 31-yard line. So that's going to be a gain of about 3 yards for the quarterback.
Yeah, Mary came through the line of scrimmage and almost had him down behind the line of scrimmage.
Okay, so they spotted instead of the 31. They spotted at the 30-yard line, so a gain of two. And again, next week we'll be in Athens at Bruce Field. That's the home field of not only the Athens Hornets, but also Trinity Valley Community College. And we'll be playing the Gatesville Hornets. Opening round of the playoffs. Third down and four. Running back coming to the left this time. And he's going to be short of the first down. He needed about 4 yards, and he picks up two to the 33-yard line.
Mary on the tackle. Also on that tackle was Jakarian Ruckbore. A lot of cousins or brothers on these teams.
Okay, we'll give him three as they spot it at the 34-yard line. We've now got 5:20 left to play here in the third quarter. Fast-moving ball game. Mainly because, Shepherd has only thrown the ball twice, and we've had the running clock for a while here in the second half. And we've only had three incompletions, so a lot of time where the clock is still moving. Okay, here's a handoff running back, and he's got the first down as he's across the 35. So he picks up about 4 yards on the play.
Drake Howard in on that tackle.
It'll be a first down for the Shepherd Pirates. First and 10 now at their 38. 4:40 and counting here in the third quarter. Glad you could join us for Bulldog football. Let's see. Mario, did you get a picture of the visitor stands over there so everyone can see our crowd? Okay, get a picture after this next handoff here, after next play. Here's a handoff to the running back going to the right. And it's going to be to the 41-yard line, a gain of three on that play.
Yeah, Bell was in there and Mary was in there. Those are future Bulldogs right there.
So if you take a look at our crowd over there, you know that there are a lot of folks listening tonight. And remember, next week the playoffs begin over at Athens. Not too bad of a drive. And, you can either go through Tyler or you can go through Jacksonville.
That's right. Come up on 278, isn't it? 75.
I think okay. I kind of prefer that Jacksonville route myself, avoid Tyler. Okay, here's second down and seven. And the handoff goes to the running back. Oh, and he's hitting the backfield for a loss.
That's Mary.
Is that Mary again?
That's
wow.
Mary, he is. Uh-oh. We've got to find another linebacker coming. And he's bigger than his brother, I think, if that's his brother.
Okay, they give him a pretty generous spot right there, I think. Okay, so it's at the 40-yard line. Third and eight. We've got 3:08 to play here in this third quarter. Carthage, if you've just joined us, led 35-0 at halftime. It's now 42-0. Snap back to the quarterback, rolling to his left. He wants to throw. This ball is incomplete off the hands of the intended receiver. And they stop the clock here again.
Number 88, Vincent Cabrata, was in on that, making him throw the ball early. Hope I said Rick Cabrata, Vincent Cabrata.
Let's see, who was that now?
Vincent Cabrata, number 88.
88.
Yeah.
Yes, way to go, Mark. That's good. Cabrata is correct. I've got all these from Beverly Allen, okay, who subs at the high school.
Who had a birthday this week.
Who had a birthday this week. That's right.
How old was she there?
Well, she won't mind. She was 70 this week. Okay, here's a head-high snap on the punt. Nobody back deep. The line of scrimmage is the 40. This is not going to be very long here. It hits at the Carthage 45 and rolls dead at the 40, so that's going to be 20 yards on that kick.
All right, we got a lot of names to mention here. We've got 71 kids over there.
And I wouldn't be surprised to see Connor Cuff on this.
That's what
one.
I'm thinking. Sometime he's going to enter the ball game. I'd love to see him.
JV quarterback.
His daddy graduated with me. Matter of fact, he was the quarterback of the football team until a kid named Audrey McMillan. And then Randall went to the defensive end, which was very effective.
It's not going to happen here. It's Rockmore back in there. Rockmore is back in as quarterback. Again, we're in the third quarter, 2:40 left to go. And here's the pitch out, the running back going to the right. And he's going to get 4 yards out to the 44. Okay, who was that,
Johnson.
Mark? Johnson. Okay. Mm-hmm. Tavarius Johnson.
He pitched it to him. He ran up to right behind the tackle and – Got good yardage there for first down.
So a gain of four makes it second and six. Again, we're coming to you live from Pirate Stadium. Beautiful night. Tell you what, we couldn't have asked for better weather for being on the roof of the press box. It was clear when the game started at 66 degrees. You can tell it's cooled off a few degrees since then. Second down and six. Okay, in the pistol. Hand off to Johnson again. Johnson, 45. Almost has a first down, but not quite.
That's 31.
31, okay.
Tavarius Johnson.
Okay, so 31. Picks up 5 yards there. And that makes it third down and one. Third and one for Carthage at their own 49-yard line. Again, if you're just joining us, this is a grass field. As best we can tell, the first game on grass for Carthage since in 8 years. Last time was 2013. Third down and one at our 49. Rockmore under center. Pitch out goes to Johnson. Or no, to 31 going left. Has a first down to the 40, 30.
He's
25
gone.
20, 15, 10. Five cuts back inside. It's a touchdown run of 51 yards. A Kane Hardware Bulldog touchdown.
All right, you got to pronounce that name again.
Okay. Let's see. 31.
You said
okay.
It.
Zamad.
Zamad.
Zamad Williams. Way to go, Zamad. 51 yards for Zamad.
He sure looked good there, didn't he? Got to the outside and went down the sidelines and outrun everybody. Had one guy to beat, cut to the inside, touchdown.
All right. Again, the extra point coming up here. This is the Bulldog stop extra point, and it is good. And the score now is 49 to nothing. Dogs 7-7 on extra points, 108
well,
to play.
Well, the Dogs are on the prowl again this year for yet another state championship. Carthage Missionary Baptist Church stands behind our kids 100% in the classroom and on the playing field. We urge them to do their best in life, to live their life for Christ, but enjoy every day as young people and use their talents to play the best game they possibly can. This is Dr. Dale Reed, pastor of Carthage Missionary Baptist Church, and go Dogs.
Because you're a fan of fresh made just the way you like it pizza, you'll love Country Fresh Pizza Carthage. We make it, you bake it. From a 10-inch to a 16-inch, even gluten-free crust is offered at Country Fresh Pizza. The Farmer's Delight features 6 meats and 6 veggies. The Vegetable Garden with all the veggies. The Rise and Shine with eggs and cheddar. The Crafty Farmer to build your own. And even Alfredo Pizza. Call 903-631-0246 to order. 636 West Panola, the white building with the bright graphics. It's delicious. It's Country Fresh Pizza.
All right, the Bulldogs getting ready to kick off here. 108 left to play in the third quarter. And here is the kick, a high one. They're going to take it back. They're going to run this one from the 8 to the 10. And he wishes he hadn't. Okay, he got it from the 8
you see this
and got to the 18. Now, if he stays there for a fair catch, he gets it to the 25, but he stopped at the 19.
Michael Dulaney, a sophomore, he stopped him in his tracks.
So first and 10 for Shepherd at their own 19. 101 left to play here in the fourth quarter. Carthage leading this one 49 to nothing. Playoffs next week start against the Gatesville Hornets, 30 miles west of Waco. The game will be played at Athens. 7 o'clock kickoff. Fake the handoff, quarterback runs it himself. And picks up pretty good yardage. He's across the 20 and across the 25 to the 26. Gain of 7 that time.
Austin Burney on the tackle. That's another name we called last week, week before last.
7 yards on that carry.
40 seconds left in the third quarter. 49-0 Bulldogs.
So this will be the final play of this quarter. And then we'll go to the fourth quarter. Carthage leading it right now 49 to nothing. Handoff goes to the running back. And he's going to have a first down as he goes across the 30 to the 32.
Vincent Cabada on the tackle.
38, Christian Lopez.
These kids are getting good, valuable playing time.
So that's a gain of 5 there.
Number 32, Tanner Lacy with the carry.
That's the last play of the third quarter. Score 49-0 Carthage. We'll be back after this.
Hope Community Medicine at Panola College's W.C. Smith Building. Office hours, 7 a.m. to 5 p.m. Monday through Thursday and 7 a.m. to 3 p.m. on Friday. To schedule an appointment, call 903-690-8395. That's 903-690-8395. They offer quality health care based on income and household size through their slide fee scale. Hope Community Medicine in Carthage.
Max Flow Chemicals of Texas is second to none for service and treatment of saltwater disposal wells. Founded in 2011 in Carthage, Max Flow's experience and dedication to service with a proven chemical program sets it apart from competitors, which includes absolute customer satisfaction at the lowest possible cost. Get an in-depth evaluation of your system for a phone call, 903-693-4600, or an email at maxflowchemicals.com. Take your disposal well's performance to the max. Maxwell Chemicals of Texas.
All right, your KGAS broadcast crew, Jerry Hansen, Mark Harris, Larry Allen, Eric Lawrence, and Mario Salazar. Mario, a Carthage High School grad and attending Panola College now. They start the clock. And here come the Shepherd Pirates up the line of scrimmage. First and 10 at their own 32. Running back going left this time. Across the 35, he's got the 40. That's a good little gain right there. It's a gain of 8 yards. Second down coming up.
Let's see who was that on the tackled by number 25. Number 24 is who made that tackle.
Brings up second
down. Jakarian Ruckmore. That's who made that tackle.
Let's see. Have we had that freshman in yet? Let's see. Who is that? What's his number? I can't find him. Okay, freshman is 46.
46.
Kydarius Matlock.
Kydarius Matlock. A lot of Matlocks come through.
Yeah,
Carthage.
That's right. Yeah, one freshman brought up for this ball game. Quite an honor for that young man. Second down and two now. And
fumble.
Ball
fumble.
Is fumble.
We got it.
And
we got
see,
it.
We got it there. Okay, that's a turnover, and we've got it at the Pirate 34-yard line. A fumble, and we pick it up.
That's number 26. Got that ball. That's a good play. Michael Delaney. A lot of Delaney's come through. Miss Matlock, I remember a Mrs. Matlock. I can't remember her first name now. It was Travis's mother. She was I think she's still alive.
Say,
in her 90s right
now.
How
many interceptions did we have in the first half? Was there one or two?
I think there's only one.
Only one? Okay, good. That's what I had, but I wasn't for sure. I might have missed one. Okay, well, let's see if we got Connor Cuff coming in here for this one.
Can't tell who the quarterback is.
I don't know who the quarterback is. Oh, it's Connor Cuff. Connor Cuff in that number 18 right there.
That's it.
Okay, so Connor Cuff, the JV quarterback, is in there. Under center, pitch out to 32. This is Johnson going right, big hole, and he's to the 25-yard line. He fumbled it, and let's see. And Shepherd comes up with it.
Yeah, he had a really good run going there.
Yep, he had a good hole that time.
And he got into the secondary, and the last second, somebody stripped it from him.
Okay, so he picks up 11. And then fumbles it.
I like that kid's stride. He's got a good stride when he gets open.
All right, remember Chalk Talk on Monday? Chalk Talk Monday at the field house. Hope you can join us there at noon. Okay, the line of scrimmage here is going to be the 24-yard line. Snap back to the quarterback. Shotgun snap. Running back coming right. And he's got the 30. So give him 6 on that play.
Jakevious McMillan on the tackle there. He's sophomore.
And we've got 9:10 to go in this one. Again, this is played on Thursday night because the Shepherd coach, just being entirely honest with Coach Surratt, said if we played on Friday, I don't have enough players to field a team because of grades. So Coach Surratt, yes, they will come down on Thursday night. Okay, so here's a handoff running back going right again, this time to the 35, to the 40. He's got a first down this time.
Mary
goes from the 30 to the 40, 10-yard gain.
Mary got him down, but not before he gained good yardage for a first down.
All right, so first down now for the Shepherd Pirates at their own 40-yard line. 8:25 to go here in the ball game. And again, we're broadcasting from the roof. And what makes this challenging is that the ladder is a straight vertical ladder going up from the press box level. Here's a hand. Oh, the quarterback keeps it himself and picks up about 3 yards. Same situation we had for years at Chapel Hill.
Yeah, there was one time 99 degrees, and the next year it was flooding. And we had to cover everything with a tarp to do the ball game.
Okay, so gain of three there.
But K-Gas was there.
And finally, in the press box level, they built this little separate room for us that we've used the last couple of times over there. But it definitely is a challenge getting the equipment up that vertical ladder. Okay, here's second down and seven. Hand off the running back straight ahead. Got another first down for them. Pretty good gain right here. It goes from the 43 down to the Bulldog 45. So that's going to be 7 and 5. That's 12 yards on that pickup.
I think that was Kubota again on the tackle. Nope, number 33 on that tackle was Drake Howard.
All right, so first and 10 now for Shepherd at the Carthage 45. It's 49-0 right now. This was senior night, incidentally, at Shepherd. Senior night, they introduced them before the ball game. Here's the handoff, the running back going left this time, and he's stopped after a gain of about one.
He was treated rudely there by Mary.
Okay, so
not
one
Mary.
Yard.
He's sticking his head in there.
And we are fast approaching the midway point here of the fourth quarter. So this game started at 6:30, and we're going to be through in less than 2 hours. Easy. And, you know, they normally last three and a half hours sometimes. So second down and nine now for Shepherd at the Carthage 44. Shotgun snap. And let's see, here's the quarterback keeping it himself. And I tell you what, that young man, quite a job there by him. He was stopped in the backfield for about a yard loss and some determined running. And he picks up a yard.
That was Mary again. He's all over the field. He reminded me of Lewis. He's sticking his head in there.
So third down and eight now. 5:50 left to go in the ball game. Third down and eight. Third and eight, shotgun snap. And here's a play-action fake. Quarterback rolling to his right. He throws. This ball is incomplete. It bounced in front of the receiver at the 37-yard line. Clock keeps rolling. They are now 0 for 4 through the air. And now, remember, Jason Wade is ill tonight, so he's not with us. He ordinarily would be manning the XL forward sideline mic. We did not have an interview with Coach Surratt at halftime. That's usually what Jason does. But Mark Harris is now starting to head down. He's going to do the after-game interview with Coach Surratt. Fourth down and eight. Here's the quarterback going to throw over the middle. This ball is incomplete. It was tipped by someone. Pretty good coverage there by the Bulldogs.
Number 25 is the one that tipped the ball.
Okay. And so that will turn it over now on downs to Carthage. Clock keeps rolling during this change of possession. So, again, we started at 6:30, and, yes, it is now 8:11. So, let's see. This is an hour and 41 minutes. We're going to make it here in an hour 50 easy. First down and 10 for Carthage at their 43-yard line. Connor Cuff is the quarterback. Pitch out goes to number 40, going to his right, and he picks up a couple of yards. Number 40 is Armando Garcia. So Garcia for a couple of yards now. And it's second and eight, 3:55 to play in the ball game. Again, the Bulldogs are going to wind up 8-0. Yeah, you usually play 10 games, but not this year. Partly due to the virus. Partly due to Hurricane Laura, and the other due to the virus that set the 5A and 6A schools back later start. We lost two 5A games in the pre-district. Here's a pitch out to the running back going to his right, and that's going to be a loss on the play from the 45 back to the 44. And again, that was Armando Garcia, a junior. So we'll call that a loss of one on the play for Garcia. 3-10 in counting now. So it's third down and nine for the Bulldogs at their own 44-yard line. Again, you know, we've mentioned it numerous times, but we want you to be aware the playoffs start next week. Yes, we will live stream it. Is that right, Jerry? Okay.
We're in the process of getting permission.
Oh,
yes.
Okay.
We've got to go to Fox Southwest.
Okay. Oh, okay. All right. So now here's a handoff to Garcia. Pitch out to Garcia. He's got a first down. And now big yardage as he's across midfield and across the 40. So that's going to go from the 44. That's going to be a Howes AC and Electrical first down. The 44 down to the Pirate 37. So 6 and 13. That's 19 yards for Garcia. And a Bulldog first down. So we've got to get permission for these playoff games. And Jerry will get that for us so you can watch them. But we'd love to have you over in Athens. At Athens Bruce Field. First down and 10 for the Bulldogs. 2 minutes to play now. 2 minutes to go. Connor Cuff, the quarterback, under center. Tight end left. In the I formation, handoff goes to Garcia. Garcia across the 35. And let's see. The line of scrimmage was the 37. And let's see what they're going to give him. They're going to give him the 33. So that's a gain of 4 on the play for Garcia. And, again, remember, we'll have Coach Surratt after the ball game with an interview. And we'll work in the stats. At some point also, we may get them in before the interview. Depends on how quickly Coach Surratt is ready for the interview. We got a minute and 16 left to play now in the ball game. The Bulldogs going to win this one. And it appears that the final score is going to wind up being 49-0 unless we score a last-second touchdown here. 2 seconds on the play clock. We get it off. There's Garcia up the middle. And he's going to have a Howes AC first down. It's going to go from the 33 down to the 26. That's going to be another Howes AC first down. And a gain of 7 for Garcia. We're going to have to run one more play. And that's going to be it. And I'll get started as quickly as I can on the stats. So maybe we can get those in before the interview with Coach Surratt. So Shepherd's going to wind up going 0-5 for District 1-9 for the season, the Bulldogs. Okay, we go into the victory formation. So it'll be a snap to Connor Cuff. And he goes to a knee, and that's it. Carthage wins this one by a score of 49-0.
Carthage Independent School District is where champions are educated. This school year is unlike any other, and CISD is rising to meet the needs of our students and community in ways like never before. Our teachers are providing stellar instruction for students both in person and virtually. We're utilizing a new and improved website to share vital information with students and parents. Help desks are in place at each campus to provide extra assistance for students navigating at-home learning. Our support professionals, principals, and central office staff are on hand to provide extra support for all Bulldogs. During these difficult times, Carthage ISD is here to help our Bulldogs continue being champions. Go Dogs!
We want you to join the winning team at Hudson Financial Group and let us assist you in finding the best game plan for your insurance and investment needs. We are licensed with over 30 companies to provide you with the best coverages and prices, whether you need personal, commercial, or life insurance. At HFG, we strive to prepare our clients for the unexpected and their future. Stop by our office at 1519 West Panola or give us a call at 903-693-7874 and let us help you with your winning game plan today. And go Dogs!
Can you hear me, Jay?
Give me the thumbs up. All right. Coach, talk to the Bulldog Nation.
I thought we played well. I mean, JV played there at the end and moved the ball and scored. And, I'm excited that we didn't have any injuries and we were on grass. We were worried about that a little bit because, they got a few holes out here. And it's frustrating for some of the seniors. They want to play more, but they're going to get all they want, hopefully, in the next 6 weeks.
Talk a little bit about next week.
We play at Athens, and we play Gatesville.
and it's a 7 o'clock contest, and you know, we're excited to get to start the third season, get into the playoffs, and hopefully we're hot and get on a roll.
You have any idea about Gatesville?
You know, I think they're 1-8, something like that, 1-7. You know, the team right now is saying happy birthday to Coach Press, so happy birthday to him. And, you know, we just got to take care of business, get better.
All right, congratulations on a great season. Thank you.
Navigating 21st century business financial currents can be trying, even for seasoned commercial endeavors. Get assistance charting your course with trustworthy commercial lending officers at Farmers State Bank, Carthage Center, Joaquin, and Shelby. FSB offers 116 years stability, a finance source for expansion and equipment purchase to help ensure growth on the path you want. Committed to East Texas business long-term success, your commercial financial request decisions are made by officers you likely know already. FSBCTX.com, Farmers State Bank, member FDIC, equal housing lender.
Friday night at Pyrrha Stadium in Shepherd, Texas, the Carthage Bulldogs were their first game on grass in the last 8 years, facing the Shepherd Pirates as they wound up district play. Carthage on the board with 11:05 left to play in the first quarter, so it only took 55 seconds, a 23-yard touchdown pass to Zay Woods. Extra point made it 7-0. 8:25 to play in the first. Mason Courtney 1 yard, 14-0. 5:46 to play in the first quarter. 10-yard pass to Montrell Hatton. It was 21-0. 46 seconds left to play in the first quarter. A 23-yard pass to Craig McNew. Carthage led 28-0 at the end of the first quarter. One score in the second quarter. 25 left to play in the half, and it was a 66-yard pass to Noah Patty. And the Bulldogs were up 35-0 at halftime. And the first score of the second half was another touchdown pass to Noah Patty, this one for 53 yards. It was 42-0, 7:15 to play in the third. And the final score of the ball game came with 1:08 to play in the third quarter, a 51-yard run by Zamad Williams. And the extra point made it 49-0. The clock ran for the entire fourth quarter, and Carthage won the ball game 49-0. Here are the statistics. Carthage with 15 first downs, and Shepherd in the ball game had 6 first downs. Carthage on the ground 131 yards, Shepherd 113. Carthage through the air 8 of 11 for 233 yards, Shepherd 0 for 5 through the air. So the total yardage, Carthage 364 and Shepherd 113. Turnovers, Carthage had 1, Shepherd with 2. Penalties, Carthage was not penalized. Shepherd had 2 for 20 yards. Carthage did not punt. Shepherd punted 4 times for a 27-yard average. The Shepherd Pirates wind up 0-5 in District 10 4A, Division 2. And for the season, they were 1-9. The Carthage Bulldogs completing their fourth straight regular season undefeated. 8-0 for the regular season, 5-0 in district play, their 11th district crown in the past 14 years. And the Bulldogs next Friday night, that'll be November 13th at 7 o'clock at Bruce Field in Athens. They will face the Gatesville Hornets in the bi-district round of the playoffs. Once again, your final score Friday night from Pirrha Stadium in Shepherd, Texas, the Carthage Bulldogs 49 and the Shepherd Pirates 0. For your Sports Beat Station, I'm Larry Allen.
You've been listening to Carthage Bulldog Football on your Sports Beat Station, KGAS. Providing the play-by-play has been Larry Allen. Our color commentator tonight has been Mark Harris. Jason Wade was on the sideline, Mike. Eric Lawrence and Mario Salazar have been providing the video. Remember to stay tuned to the East Texas Scoreboard Show immediately following our broadcast. For our entire Sports Beat team, I'm Jerry Hansen saying so long, everyone.